First day of June 2016 on this Wednesday edition. We kick it off with a report from John Bowne.
Social justice warriors, forget all of the death threats you have spewed out towards Donald Trump, deeming him a bigot simply because you can't swallow the truth. Reality is on the verge of entering the comfort zone you so adamantly defend. The tsunami of immigration strategized by Bilderberg elites to divide and conquer the U.S. and Europe is only growing stronger and more dangerous as the days roll by. And now, as London's newly elected pro-caliphate mayor strengthens the foothold of Sharia law, it appears jolly old England may be the first country to completely fall if nothing is done. Breitbart UK reports. Up to 500,000 migrants and their families who have fled from the Middle East, North Africa, and elsewhere could head to the UK after 2020 under European Union free movement rules. Between 240,000 and 480,000 may travel to UK, and while countries such as Greece, Italy, and Germany have been hardest hit by the migrant crisis so far, a secondary wave will likely move on to Britain once they have the right. Meanwhile, as Obama is challenged by 26 states on the constitutionality of the 2014 DAPA program, the dam has completely burst as a surge of unchecked illegal immigrants entering the United States swells into record numbers. WCQS reports, immigrants fleeing gang violence in Central America are again surging across the U.S.-Mexico border, approaching the numbers that created an immigration crisis in the summer of 2014. While the flow of immigrants slowed for much of last year, nothing the U.S. government does seems to deter the current wave of travelers. Yet the numbers are daunting. From last October to March, the U.S. Border Patrol averaged 330 apprehensions of Central Americans a day, according to an analysis by the Pew Research Center, an increase of 100% over the same time period a year earlier. And it's not just the surging numbers of criminals given the revolving door into the United States, freely killing and, yes, raping U.S. citizens, or the quiet strengthening of Sharia communities in the United States that is fully underway.
We have had Somalians here once they got on that special alien list. They won't tell us that anymore, but there have been Somalians, India, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Chinese, you name it, we've had it here.
But as one of them was climbing over the fence, he dropped a package. And that package was an Urdu dictionary. Urdu is a language spoken in Pakistan and Afghanistan. And in that translation book, Urdu and English, there were a lot of phrases circled and outlined. Do you speak Spanish? Do you speak English? So it's easier for them to slip through this private property.
Disease lives inside this Trojan horse.
The rates of tuberculosis infections are rising for the first time in nearly 20 years. And the evidence points to people coming from overseas to the United States. Our own investigation has found that everyone, U.S. born or foreign born, who lives in a refugee resettlement area is at risk for contracting tuberculosis.
An outbreak of measles, a highly contagious measles that began with an inmate at the Eloy Detention Center, has now grown to 11 confirmed cases.
And now state, county health officials are working to try to stop it from spreading further.
Breitbart reports a flesh-eating tropical disease is ravaging the war-torn Middle East after Islamic State destruction created the ideal breeding conditions. The parasitic disease called cutaneous leishmaniasis, also known as the Aleppo evil, is caused by bites from tiny infected sandflies, which thrive in the squalid conditions left in the wake of the Islamic State terror and conflict. The number of cases has shot up from just 6 in 2012 to thousands just a year later. The U.S. Center for Disease Control and Prevention reported that the disease has recently begun to flourish in Syria's neighboring countries. The time has come to shut down George Soros' social justice warriors wreaking havoc on the narrative. Freedom of speech is needed now more than ever. Ignorance can't be the darkened midnight path we lead our families and fellow Americans down. This trail winds its way towards certain doom, emboldened by our own inaction. John Bowne for InfoWars.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're live. The big broadcast kicks off now. Well, it's already June 1st, 2016 on this Wednesday worldwide live broadcast. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We're going to be here, obviously, for the next 4 hours. David Knight will host the fourth hour. Joe Biggs is following a Breitbart politically incorrecture in California, where the social justice warriors try to block free speech everywhere it's taking place, a truly monstrous group of people. We have a bunch of the videos up on Infowars.com. We're writing articles about them right now, just what happened last night with the kickoff of the tour. But we can't obviously play them here because the social justice warriors do not have any forms of English other than just screaming, frothing, and cussing. Headline, social justice warrior whiners attempt to block free speech at UCLA. That's too kind of a headline. Anti-free speech goons attempt to destroy free speech at a university again. I mean, that's what they're doing. And they revel in it. And this is not some aberration. Everywhere you go, you are faced with the Age Skrillex and the Trigglypuffs of the world. That's their meme names, who just absolutely want to shut freedom in this country down. They do not want to let you speak. They do not want to let you raise your children the way you see fit. They want to run your life, period. That's all it comes down to. And we have to exercise our free speech or lose it, because here's the big news. All over Europe and now in the United States, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Google, Apple platforms are censoring populist speech, nationalist speech, conservative speech, libertarian speech, Christian speech, leftist speech that's concerned about Islam, you name it. Now, by the way, if you're in Mongolia or you're in Tibet or you're in India especially, you're afraid of Muslims. Because there are bombings every day for the last 60, 70 years, and shootings and beatings and stabbings every day against Buddhists and against Hindus and against other groups that traditionally get along with each other. But the Muslims come in and try to take over. That's why the Dalai Lama has come out against radical Islam and warned Germany to stop opening its borders and stop killing itself. Because to people in China and Tibet and Japan and all over, they are, what on earth are you doing? They were all attacked by booby pirates. That's where the term booby comes from, is an Islamic pirate. That all over the South Pacific. I mean, you know, Islam took over most of the South Pacific and all around Australia. And I mean, you know that, right? The only place they didn't get was the Philippines. I mean, everybody knows that, right? No, people don't know that. It wasn't just Europe that got overrun. It wasn't just Russia that got overrun. It wasn't just Poland. It wasn't just Romania and Hungary and Serbia and Greece and Rome. Rome had to build big walls around Vatican City because of the Islamic invasions. And then the people showing up are screaming, we're here to invade. We're here to take over. We're here to get your women. White people are bad. Everyone's like, oh, I'm white. I'm evil. You slit my throat. It's wild. And again, we're not bringing in the Muslims from areas of Iraq or areas of Jordan or even areas from Egypt, where they really do like the West on average and really do just want to have civilization. We're bringing in the Saudi brainwashed Wahhabist. In fact, there's new numbers out today where they claim out of the couple thousand refugees they brought to the United States so far this year in the last 6 months, because we're kicking off the 6 month, yeah, so almost 6 months here, that there's almost zero Christians. 1,037 Syrian refugees admitted in May, two Christians. That's 0.19. Syria is 20% plus Christian. It was almost 30. Hundreds of thousands got killed. Another 10% got out, but they're not allowed to go into Europe. Christians are blocked by Germany, by France, by Sweden. Because you heard the Pope 2 weeks ago, he said, Europe should be embarrassed by its traditional Christian roots. But he used a term much worse than it was. He abhors and is repulsed. Well, what was the exact word? It was repulsed or abhorred. We can pull up the LaCroix newspaper. We have the English translation on Infowars.com. And he just talks about how horrible it is and how good it is this is happening because Christian Europe is bad. And that Jesus sent his disciples out like ISIS did. I mean, this is stuff I'd expect to hear at some satanic mass with black altars. It's the kind of stuff they spew out of their mouths, you know, blasphemy. But now it just flows open blasphemy out of the Pope's mouth like a satanic high priest. I mean, where are the, you know, women over the altars? And the Pope kisses the rose of Venus shame. Let's put him back up on screen. Put him up there. Pope Palpatine compares Christianity to ISIS. Go watch my original report. But if we go back to the actual text in the article you had previously, thank you for pulling up so quick. We don't script this, folks. They're just going and gunning as I talk about it. Pope Francis likens Jesus to ISIS, says Muslims must breed with Europeans. Francis claims ISIS is similar to Jesus, sending his disciples into all nations. And then he went on. In a shocking interview, Pope Francis likens Jesus Christ to ISIS. Today, I don't think there is fear of Islam as such as ISIS and its war of conquest, which is partly drawn from Islam, he told the French paper LaCroix. Quote, it is true that the idea of conquest is inherent in the soul of Islam. However, it is also possible to interpret the objective in Matthew's gospel, where Jesus sends his disciples to all nations, in terms of the same idea of conquest. The opposite. The Pope also said he, quote, dreaded hearing about Christian roots of Europe because to him they take on colonialist overtones, close quote. He called on European nations, quote, to integrate Muslim migrants into the continent. Yeah, I bet those German girls are going to love not being able to wear those aren't even so much German outfits as they are. What's the more classical liberal area of Germany that's more libertarian? Kind of like the Texas of Germany. I'm having one of those momentary blips on my mental capacity. They call it a brain flatulence, I guess, would be the proper nomenclature.
Bavaria.
Thank you. Bavaria. There you go. I always love running into German Bavarians. I don't think I've run into any Bavarians that aren't listeners. I'll be on trips. You know, Germans are probably the most prolific travelers out there, maybe after the Japanese. It's a cliche. It's a stereotype because statistically it's true. It's like Americans have the least amount of passports of any free country. It's like Kim Jong-un looks like a psychopath. Anyways, excuse me. It's just facts. But getting back to the news and information here. Where was I? Oh, yes. They are opening up the borders at a very rapid clip and allowing TB in at massive levels and spreading everywhere. People are dying from it. It's so glorious because the government wants to protect you and wants to keep you safe. And now even Reuters is forced to report on the latest sexual assaults. Asylum seekers investigated over sex attacks at German festival. Now, it was reportedly 27 women were groped or raped or both. But now by the time it hits our news, three Pakistani men seeking asylum in Germany are being investigated after dozens of women said they were sexually harassed at a music festival over the weekend, prosecutors said. All you got to do is buy them a beer and talk to them, guys. You don't need to try to rape them. I understand you see a free woman out. It's like fair game because they're slaves in a lot of your countries, but I understand I'm an evil person and I don't like that. And so the feminists don't like me because I don't want to have women chained up and sexually mutilated. But if women want to be in slave galleys, they know where to go. The accusations follow mass sexual attacks on women at New Year's Eve in Cologne, which the police were ordered to cover up. But the police later leaked it, so we know the truth, which fueled a backlash against Chancellor Angela Merkel's open-door migrant policy. Of course, the answer is when they vote out the government, they just have an election fraud, so they don't get voted out. After the festival in the western city of Darmstadt, do I pronounce that right, which attracted 300,000 to 400,000 people over 4 days, 26 women made complaints of harassment, and there are officially 18 injured parties, a spokeswoman for prosecutors said on Wednesday. But they've got the rug up, sweeping it under immediately. The women complained that they were surrounded by a small group of men who then touched them inappropriately, a police spokesman said. Of course, we know about what happened in Cologne and everywhere else. We're doing everything they can to cover this up. Because if you got an unattended woman, even if she's wearing long dress and stuff, she is fair game. And if you can rape her, then you can even go to the public execution a month later where they chop her head off in front of everybody because you raped her. The men don't get in trouble. But see, nothing from Gloria Steinem, nothing from the CIA-run Miss Magazine Combine, nothing from Sumner Redstone and Viacom, nothing from any of these people. Nothing. Because they want to trash the West from one end to the other, because they know the West, time and time again, has overthrown tyranny, and they don't want there to be any escape from the final technotronic takeover. Here's the headline. Dalai Lama, this is from French news agency, Germany cannot become an Arab country, EU taking too many refugees. But that's impossible. The Dalai Lama has brown skin. And there's been this giant long-term demonization campaign of the Dalai Lama. That's because the Chinese government has taken over that country and is forcing the Tibetans to breed themselves out. And I think some of the left have lionized the Tibetans a little too much, but I've studied it. It's a pretty interesting culture. It's an ancient culture. And it's a culture that the Muslims tried to overrun before. So they're not stupid. And they know that they won't be allowed to practice their religion if the Muslims take over. See, let's find that. The Muslims aren't tolerant. They're not tolerant. So anyone that is tolerant is concerned. Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., we're live 4 hours. Rebroadcast on fine stations across the country. We also return 7 o'clock Central, InfoWars Nightly News. Okay, let me start plowing into some of the political news here in the United States. And then I'm, after the break, going to get into the really big news. This is out of Defense One, so that's basically the one of the mouths of the Pentagon. So when you hear talk like this, it's serious. Beijing is setting the stage for war in the South China Sea. That's out of Defense One. And you see the communist Chinese generals and Navy admirals being quoted by the People's Daily and others saying, we are preparing for war with the United States and Japan. So that is the type of big issues we've got that we need to focus in on. Meanwhile, the big headline around the world is Amazon CEO, we should settle Mars because it's cool. And even though I don't like Bezos' activity when it comes to politics, supporting Obozo, I do like the fact that he promotes space travel and innovation because that's exactly what we need. And yeah, we should settle Mars because it's cool. Now, let's continue here. Let me get into this little giblet of news that is one of the most important of the day, obviously, and I intend to open the phones up and get your take on this. The establishment's like a pack of wolves, and Hillary's blackmailing people, and she knows where the bodies are buried, and she's got so many other people in government involved in corruption with her. That's her real protection. Going back to Ken Starr not going after her for the missile secrets to the communist Chinese when she was co-president with Laura Allen Hughes. True high treason. But then now he basically works for the Clintons and praises them. And it's the same story today. But at a certain point when it all comes out in the open, her private email server, Benghazi, the persecution of Christians, all of it, at a certain point in the court of public opinion, they have to bring her down. It's just too ridiculous. The story's from Zero Hedge. It's up on InfoWars.com. WikiLeaks ask if this is the smoking gun email that will bring down Hillary Clinton. And strangely enough, the FBI, Kurt Nemo is writing, it's smoking gun evidence in Clinton email scandal. WikiLeaks cable shows Clinton willfully abused confidential documents. And this has been out a while, but I'm glad it's now getting a little bit of attention. Here's a copy of the email if you're a TV viewer. Here it is. Classified U.S. Department of State number F-224 or 214-20439 December doc number, and then it goes to the doc number C0578759. And this is from the Secretary of State. And it says, if they can't turn into non-paper with no identifying heading and send non-secure. So she's saying, an abbreviation, if they can't send it to me the way I want it, cut the top off and send it to me as non-secure. This has been known for years. It's from 2011. And Hillary then has the nerve, I'm going to play this clip, to go on television yesterday and say, quote, on CNN, she claims it's obvious that she always puts national security over self-interest and that personal email use was a common practice, that's a quote, under other secretaries of state, urges voters to look at the big picture and the full threat posed by a Donald Trump presidency. Because they're the ones turning ISIS and Al-Qaeda loose in the world. They're the ones giving missile secrets to the communist Chinese. They're the ones starting war with Russia. They're the ones just running around destabilizing everything to bring in a world government out of the crisis. And they say Donald Trump's the problem and that she's standing up for national security when she takes money from all these foreign dictators at her foundation to then sign waivers at the State Department to give them high-tech weapon systems. Let's play the clip.
Is it a challenge that you have to face to convince voters you'll put national security ahead of your own interests?
Well, I think that is obvious. I always have. And the report, just to go back to the actual report, makes it clear that personal email use was the practice under other secretaries of state, and that the rules that they are now referencing were not clarified until after I had left. But look, I've said many times it was still a mistake, and if I could go back, I would do it differently.
She lied about it, though.
And I understand people may have concerns about this, but I hope voters look at the full picture of everything I've done in my career and the full threat posed by
Donald Trump. We know what you've done in your career, Hillary. Thank you.
I have faith in the American people.
Yeah, you have faith in the American people, right? You've done everything you can to ship our jobs overseas, take our guns, dumb our kids down, and make us be obsessed with psychological warfare, tranny garbage. We'll be back. Stay with us. Now, 20, 30 years ago, you'd tell people that the Federal Reserve was a private central bank, and they'd say, you're a racist or you're a conspiracy theorist. Now it's, you know, 5, 6 years, it's on CNN, it's on ABC News. Oh, yeah, we're run by foreign banks. They're above the law, don't pay taxes, and we pay our taxes to them mainly, and they control us. That's how far the liberty movement's come. That's how far you've come, spreading the word and waking people up. Alex Jones here. Thank you for joining us. I want to get more into geopolitical news and open the phones up and get into the latest on Trump, really going after Katie Couric. See, that's smart. Destroy these media whores. Destroy these evil deceivers to help expose the entire Brian Williams media. In fact, that's the name. Not the dinosaur media, not the prostitute media, not the Decepticon media, not the collaborator media, not the scum media, not the filth media, not the anti-American media, not the predator media, not the state-run media. No, not the media whore system, but the Brian Williams media. That's it, the Brian Williams con artist fraud media. That's Hillary. She's in combat. Sniper attacks. There's video. No such thing. Just like Brian Williams and Katie Couric. Let's see. The reason the story's so big, and I'm going to get to it, the reason I've been harping on it for over a week since it broke over at, or was it like Breitbart and Drudge and everywhere, is because the gun owners that were interviewed were smart enough with their smartphones to use the little tech systems against Big Brother and record her knowing she'd set them up. And guess what? She did. They're using old tactics in a new war. And the dinosaurs are dropping faster and faster. And that just warms my little heart. Because when you look at Katie Couric, she's a sparkly-eyed white devil preying on you and your family. Louis Farrakhan's looking for white devils? Let me tell you, there's one right there. Hey, we should have the White Devil Award. I tell you, a lot of evil people running this thing are white. But they're not me, and I'm not, you know, there's a lot of evil people and other groups, too. But I tell you, a lot of these people are disproportionately white. And they're posing as liberals preying on people when they have armed guards. And I'm sick of that sack of garbage. She knows full well that guns are good. She's got guns. So's Barbara Boxer and Dianne Feinstein. They just don't want you to have a gun because they're a big, fat, stinking predator. It's time to call them out. Then I'm going to get into Beijing is setting the stage for war in the South China Sea. Defense One. Are you Sauron? No, I am the mouth of Sauron. I'm not saying the Pentagon's Sauron, but it's funny because it pretty much is the mouth of the Pentagon. The Ministry of Death. Before it was the Ministry of War, but propagandists, Edward Bernays said, call it the Defense Department. Why not just call it the Ministry of Death? I mean, good or bad, that's what it deals, is death. I'm not even against our military. I want to take it back over for America. not have it be hijacked by the globalists. But let's just get honest. It's like calling progressive. Everything with them is a sick joke. Progressive like brain tumors or melanoma or leukemia or spongiform encephalopathy, prions, mad cow disease. I mean, it's not a good thing. Progressive. Your cancer is progressing. Your heart disease is progressing. Oh, yes. But they're eugenicists who want us to go backward and be controlled and live in a post-industrial age while they enjoy the fruits of high tech that we develop and build. Then they just test on us. See? So they don't want us to progress. So it's even more of a lie. You can say it's progressing like cancer, but it's actually regressive. I am a progressive. I am a Renaissance man. I want to build. I want to see you so prosperous. I have dreams for the species. I want to share them with others and our children to go on into the future with their children forever. School's out for summer. School's been blown to pieces. We don't need any education. We don't need no thought control, no dark sarcasms in the classroom. Hey, teachers, leave them kids alone. Get off our backs. Let us go to the next level. Don't try to suppress us anymore, controllers, because you're really not teachers. You want to keep us like cattle, a cross between gremlins and minions. What would you call that? A gremlin, a grim men, a grim men. A new creature has just been developed. I'm sure it'll be a new internet meme. But we actually want to go to space. We want to go to the next level of species, and we're here to push it, period. Free will. We're here to show folks the rabbit trick, show people the hat trick, so the scammers can't rule the world and so that innovators can lead the world. See, I don't want to rule. I want to lead. And I want to see others that have got better right stuff than I do, and I want to put them up front and launch them and support them. And I want to see them support me right back. And I want to see them charge hard against parasites and enemies and run them over for this species. Full gear, full power, automatic, maximum, more of it now. Period. Nothing's stopping us. God made us. The vision is unstoppable. It's not megalomania of an individual. It is the animating contest of beauty and creation and discovery. And a vision, a true purpose-driven life. That's why everything we do here is about empowering you, because when you're empowered, we're empowered. When you raise your awareness, when you raise your consciousness, I don't mean that new age mumbo jumbo. I mean literally, your brainwaves go up in study after study. Other people's in the room, even if they're asleep, go up. I want the brainwaves up. I want the spiritual understanding intensified. I want to see everyone succeed. How many losers do we know that think to win, somebody else has to fail? Yes, in classic animal competition, that's the case. Not in the innovative system of humans where we build our own reality. We create our own environment. Look at where we were 1,000 years ago, 5,000 years ago, and look where we are today, and imagine that would be unthinkable to people 1,000 years ago. And the levels we're going to go to are going to be so fantastical once we make it past this next hurdle that it's going to be undreamt of. And the people in the future are going to love us for what we did, and they're going to love their children and their progeny going forward, and we're all in kinship together forever in the great victory, in the great species ascension. And the globalists want to strangle us in the crib and sacrifice us to the devil, the whole planet like a baby. That's what it is. It's a big egg. The planet is a big launch base. The planet is an egg. Quite frankly, it's meant to be consumed, probably. But we will build a trillion worlds. The globalists don't want you to know this. They're total filth. I'm going to stop right now. Buckley's been talking about this, and then we'll be back in the news, for 6 months, or actually longer. The folks that run the biggest storable food system in the country, they've only been around about 7-8 years. They've become the dominant group because of the best prices, the best quality, You know, it's run by all the great folks up in Utah. They're the experts on trouble foods and inventions and, you know, all the rest of it. So much of the dental stuff in the country gets developed up in Utah. My dad, back when he was still a dentist, would travel there a lot on big supply missions to make deals. They're very innovative folks up in Utah in that area. And they have designed incredible water filtration systems, the Alexa Pure, gee, I wonder where they got the name, that you hear it sold all over talk radio, you name it. We have it at the lowest prices at InfoWarsStore.com. Very high-quality gravity-fed system that just absolutely cuts out hundreds of different pathogens and chemicals and hundreds of others. It lowers it to nearly non-detectable. But, you know, scientifically, they can still, with spectrometers, find, you know, 1/1,000,000th of whatever in it, of this or that. But it basically cuts everything out. Glyphosate, fluoride, lead, mercury, arsenic, you know, all these different fuel additives. I mean, it's just our water table is super, 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 you know, contaminated. Well, now they've launched something many years in the making. I've been hearing about it for 6 months. It's here. It's introduced today at the lowest price ever. I have air filters in my house because of all the bad pollen here in Central Texas. This thing has ratings as good as units I have that cost me $1,000. And it's super quiet and lightweight and is the next level. And it's so inexpensive. I expect this to be one of our best-selling products ever and to help fund the InfoWar and the small profit we do make. But Buckley's here to tell us about the Alexa Pure Breeze, which operates as a fan. It's super quiet. It cleans the air. Every major room in your house really should have one of these because, you know, we put air filters on our cars. We put water filters on the water for our bodies. But what we're breathing is so important as well. That's why I have it in my computer, you know, on my calendar when it's time to change the filters in the house and change the filters in my car. Because it makes it manageable to be in the worst area for allergies in the United States is awesome. I mean, it's hands down. And I thought it was hypochondria. My friends in Dallas would have it, you know, back playing football or whatever. And then I moved here. I'm like, what on earth is this? This is how I manage the allergies. Plus, I take, you know, some of the herbal remedies that are basically just the plant itself. That's been helping me. And wild honey. But I'm telling you, this is something everybody needs, especially in your baby's room, your children's room. Babies can't tell you that their nose is clogged up with all the artificial garbage. The houses are so toxic. Buckley, tell us about Alexa Pure Breeze, discounted over 25% off as an introductory promotion to $184. I mean, at the normal price, it's already a steal, and you're supporting the InfoWar. Tell us about Alexa Pure Breeze.
Well, you know, you were talking about innovations and products that make, you know, humanity be able to progress and to be stronger and to be more clear-eyed. Well, this is definitely one. We've been working on this for a long time. We've rejected a lot of different models, a lot of them.
From other companies.
Exactly, from other companies.
I'm just blown away by these guys always come up with great stuff.
That had, you know, weird ozone smells, or they were too loud, or other problems and issues that they had. The filters were too expensive because that's the way they got you. You bought the unit, and then later on you had to buy expensive filters. So at any rate, this is really, really amazing. It's the Alexa Pure Breeze. We're really proud to have partnered with the guys up there in Utah. And it's an energy-efficient HEPA ion cluster air purification system. And right now, we're selling it for the lowest price available anywhere. It's only available one other place on the internet, and we're selling it for the introductory offer of $184.99, which is over 25% off retail. Equivalent units, the cheapest equivalent unit costs $259.95, and there are other units that are up to $899 to $1,000 that do exactly what this unit does, but they're not as quiet. Because this one has a silent mode, which runs at 16 decibels, and it's quieter.
I can't even hear it. It's on, right?
Yeah, it's running. It's running right now, and I'll put the microphone up to it, and you can't even hear it. Literally, it's super quiet. But however, beyond being quiet, it has a four-stage purification process that that creates superior air quality. It has a HEPA filter, and it has other filters that go inside of it. There's a pre-filters and a carbon-activated filters. And the most amazing thing about it is that it has this patented ion cluster technology that kills airborne microbes with a final byproduct of clean water, not ozone. Because there's a lot of units out there that do that, that will sterilize the air. They will take out toxins and microbes and biological particles out of the air, but you always come back into the room and the room smells, you have that ozone smell. And as a matter of fact, if you leave a room sealed and you have one of those running,
toxic.
It is toxic and it's kind of dangerous. So this is non-toxic. It's a beautiful unit. It really looks good. I mean, it will look beautiful in your house in a corner, but beyond that, it is really, really powerful.
It looks very modern.
Absolutely. And the value is amazing. At $184, you know, you could probably buy a couple of these for different places in your house.
And the small profit we make, which we're free market, that's good to make profit. We're not going to be arguing taxpayer money or MSNBC. We, you know, this is free will association. Whatever the most innovative, cool stuff is, like the units we sell that will charge like, you know, dozens of different phones and appliances and jump your car a dozen times, and it's like a third the size of a briefcase. And, you know, it's the very best unit. When a new, even better unit comes out, we'll buy thousands of those and sell those. It's like whatever's the coolest stuff, we're always adding it to InfoWarsStore.com to promote and fund ourselves with things that we ourselves like and use and have tested and think are great. You know, it's real simple. That's what we do at InfoWarsStore.com. We want to thank you. You're funding true independent media this way. So folks who check that out, InfoWarsStore.com. Check out the Alexa Pure family of water filters that are excellent as well. Pro Pure is excellent as well. There's again, there's a lot of great brands out there, but we carry whatever's the highest quality at the lowest prices. 10% off promo code WATER on the water filtration. But this, is there a promo code needed on this?
There is no promo code. We have slashed the price to over 25% off of retail, and it's only $184.99 right now. The price is going to go up soon, like within a few days, because this is an introductory offer only. And the reason why is we want a lot of people out there to try it and give us their feedback on the website. All of our other products are rated 4.5 to 5 stars plus.
Yeah, notice there's no ratings yet because we just started doing this 5 minutes ago.
Exactly. So please purchase one of these units at this really, really low cost.
And give us your real review. You know, that's what I mean. It's a third party review site. And we want to see what you think. But we love this. I'm going to put a bunch. In fact, I'm going to replace those big, giant $1,000 ones because I looked at the ratings. But I bought those years ago, so stuff's going down in price. And this is a $184 unit. I mean, I guess I get it for like $140. That's our big profit, like $40, folks. But we sell a lot of them, though, so it'll help fund the operation. I mean, I want a bunch of these. I want these in the office. We already have some in the office, but I'm always, turn that ozone thing off. That's toxic. And we only put them out like if, you know, it floods and something leaks and the carpet stinks, you know. We bring those things out, but they're still not good for regular use in my research view. You can have your own opinion all day if you want. Yeah, that stuff will kill bacteria and stuff, but it will also, you know, not too hot for you, in my view.
And, you know, one thing that I encourage everybody to do is go and just look up online the toxicity of being inside all the time. And now, in this current age, we're inside the vast majority of the time. Hardly do we ever get outside in the sun. We're usually out inside doing something in our office or at home. And the houses have all kinds of stuff that's outgassing. Just look into it. I'm not going to tell you what the story is, but just go and Google that and look at a toxicity.
Sure, sure. Well, it's well known. Inside. Great job, Alexa Pure. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com for all the nutraceuticals. Buckley, thank you so much, my friend. And make sure I get a whole bunch of those for myself. All right, we're going to go to break, and I'm going to get into the big China news. Support our local affiliates as well. Become local sponsors is just as important to support our local stations. Hell, send them $100, put a billboard up for our local affiliates. That is just as important as supporting our broadcast and getting the new Alexa Pure Breeze system. When we come back, Beijing is setting the stage for war in the South China Sea. It's a big, thick, 20-something page report from Defense One. We're going to break it down. Stay with us. You're the pretender. You pretend you have a right to rule over humanity when you can't even rule your own self, you parasites. And now, we are faced with the communist Chinese with their perfected Long March missiles in the 1990s that couldn't get off the launch pad half the time. Rarely could get into orbit. And now they've done Chinese missile tests where they fire them over the North Pole and into the Atlantic North Sea. You look at a globe, you know, we don't fire nukes at Russia around the world. We shoot it over the top. It's a very short distance. That's how Russia fires its missiles. And that's how China fires its ICBMs. But then, of course, they've got sea launch systems that are copies of U.S. submarine-based missiles and cruise missiles, exact copies, everything from our TOW anti-tank missiles right down to our howitzers. China has it all. And our government made deals with them to move most of our industry there to not help the Chinese people, but to help the megabanks consolidate control. And now, there is a huge Defense One report. Beijing is setting the stage for war in the South China Sea. But Hillary told ABC News just last week that she's tough on national security And she just told CNN that last night. She said, it's obvious to voters I will put national security over self-interest. She said that. I played the clip earlier in the hour. If you just joined us, not playing it again. Because I don't want to hear her voice. It's like metal nails on a chalkboard. I absolutely hate that noise, don't you? Gives me the willies. And Hillary Clinton has that effect on me. And I've tried to get to where it doesn't happen. But when I see her with that big Joker smile, I am repulsed. I am physically see her as a vampire. I mean, if I saw that in the dark pop up with that big, think about the illusion. So that's her just looking ugly. Look at the one. Just type in Hillary scary smile. And man, I just got chills thinking about her. I mean, she is an evil entity. Anyways, side issue. That's who with her evil crone undead husband. That's more a goofy one. She's got these. You see the one where she has this fake smile? We were showing it earlier. It's like, yeah. I mean, yeah, that's what she really looks like. I mean, she is a psychotic. Look at her. A psychotic demon out to mount our head on the wall. She wants to dominate us. And you know what? She is dominating us. She rules us. It shows how pathetic we are.
Including FBI officials looking into whether national security was compromised because...
Get her off! I'm not kidding. I can't... People think I'm joking. I'm not kidding, okay? I'm sick of her squatting on me, ruling me, hurting my family, and selling us out. And now the Pentagon admits China's gearing up for war. These traitors have sold us out. These people make you want to throw up, and all their idiot moron followers, the scum of the earth, the dumbest, most pathetic people on the planet that follow this worm. You want to fight? Oh, you're going to get one. Oh, I'm just dumping my full will on you. Just feel this lean up against you. I hate you, dual order. Oh, it feels good. Had enough of these people, excuse me. I just overdosed on Hillary Clinton and went into absolute panic mode. That's okay. Yes, Hillary makes me go crazy. I was actually laughing during the break. It's like a 70-second break. I started watching the video. It's up on Infowars.com. Let's get this queued up. Threat to freedom. Feminist goons wage war on free speech. Look at how that woman looks. Talk about scramble brain. And it says threat to freedom. First Amendment now attacked as much as the second. And I love the new name Biggs has given her. Alice the Goon. And look, these are dangerous anti-free speech people. So they need to be demonized. Because they're not letting us try to have our free speech. And they are acting like demons. So you're not demonizing them when you point out what they've done. We need to exercise our free speech or lose it to these authoritarians. This woman has the same look in her eye as, like, you know, I see like Chinese police when they're dragging some dissident off. And just look at her. I mean, that thousand-yard stare, she thinks people at a university being able to speak some libertarian gay guy is sick of people telling him what he can and can't do, what words he can use. So we're going to get that guy on the show. Biggs is out there covering it. He's like the Breitbart editor for tech. And they just are crazy. It says Alice the Goon and her fellow feminists. These aren't empowering women. Look at these women. Want to eradicate the First Amendment because free speech hurts their feelings. And again, I'm not against these women because they, I don't know what they're into. But, you know, she looks like she's into the Rachel Maddow, Janet Reno style selection. And I mean, you know, I'm the same way. I don't like having to mess with my hair and stuff. I got short hair. I mean, I've done a lot of women who have short hair. I mean, that's fine. You know, dress like a guy or whatever. My big thing is you just need to leave me alone. Let me have my own life. That's how that works. Because you have no idea what I do in my life. You have no idea what I'm into. You have no idea in your little fantasy land how people actually operate. And you want to just tell everybody what to do. And then we're going to follow your roadmap. You see, let's say I agree with you 80%, which I don't. But let's just say I agree with you 100%. You're not going to dictate to everybody how they talk and what they do. You understand that. That's not liberal. And so we're going to ridicule you because you need to be ridiculed. You are a joke. Your These people are trying to block things, and these social justice warriors and Black Lives Matter are trying to violently push police horses over and laugh when the horse breaks its leg and then has to be killed. And there's video of them celebrating and whooping and hooping and running around. These people are aggressive. They're dangerous. Most of them want to lock conservatives up in FEMA camps. And they're out of control. Now, I want to be able to play these videos for you, but there's so much cussing. I know we have a limited crew, but by the time Biggs gets here, and a lot of folks are on vacation right now, it's kind of summer vacation time. We have a skeleton crew right now. Can somebody get me some of these at least so I can play some of them? Because they are golden. And of course, we should send it all off to the Drudge mothership. You know, these are funny headlines, but threat to freedom, feminist goons wage war on speech. First Amendment now attacked as much as the second. And I would just say threat to freedom, crazed feminists try to block free speech in California. I mean that's what it is. So Alice the Goon is set to probably be a new meme. Now, she's not going to be as good as Carl the Cuck or AIDS Skrillex, according to the popular nomenclature. I don't know their real names, and other people. You're a white male. I have got literally hundreds of really important news items that in the next 2-3 hours, we're going to at least mention most of them here today. A lot of clips I want to play. We're now into the second hour. Thank you for joining us. Before we go to Pastor Manning, who is a monthly guest with us of Otlo World Church based in Harlem, and to get his analysis, let me throw a few stories out for stations that just joined us. Despite the fact that I have hundreds of stories, I'm going to go back to something I've been covering for over a week and really hammering. And I love Donald Trump's instincts because 9 times out of 10, he goes with what I'm already covering days after we are hammering it. And days after Drudge is hammering it, or somebody like Pastor Manning, who's met with him several times, is hammering, he just gets the zeitgeist. He's like us. He doesn't like the tyranny. And Katie Couric has had her Brian Williams moment in this documentary we covered a whole bunch the last few weeks, where she asked them, well, you know, how do you stop criminals from getting guns without background checks? And the answer is criminals will always get guns without background checks. So you have more guns to counter them, and that causes a lower crime rate historically. And they all answered that way. She just cut to them sitting there in the chairs. We've already covered it, but for new listeners, it's the Katie Couric gun documentary controversy. Just Google that. You'll get hundreds of stories. And she's already, you know, nobody wants to watch her. Nobody likes her. She's already washed up, failure, a loser, as Trump tweeted. But now he's talking about her, giving, you know, when he gives speeches, how she's emblematic of the sleazy media. In fact, let's cue it up and play it since you guys were able to draw that up so fast, because this is so central. I've had them do stuff like this to me. Or I've had them, when I've been on CNN Live via satellite, cut my audio off for 10 seconds. And then the host is going, answer my question. Why won't you answer it? And you're going, and they're asking you if you're a racist, or they're asking you if you support the Boston bombing. And then later you get off and your phone's ringing and everybody's like, why didn't you answer that? This is what they did to Trump on the thing with whatever his name is, the Klansman, David Duke. I mean, they cut your audio off. You're sitting there asking, excuse me, what was that question? He already said dozens of times he didn't like David Duke. He said it a decade ago before it was ever a controversy. But see, this is how they do it. But why it's important is I figured out about a decade ago and would start telling CNN, as I've been on there probably 40, 50 times over the years, and Fox and others, but CNN was the worst. CNN is the most deceptive. MSNBC is openly evil and worse overall, but CNN's more deceptive. You know, blue screens. They say they're in Iraq. They're in Atlanta. Blue screens up at the tragic events in Newtown. I don't know what's going on at CNN, but they're very deceptive is what I'm getting at. But the reason I bring this story up first to Pastor Manning, then we'll cover the waterfront that he wants to get into, is we started recording it and started telling CNN we're recording the whole thing with our own camera in the studio, because they have a satellite studio, you know, here in Austin. And that's when they quit interviewing us entirely, because they couldn't game things and manipulate it. They would tape it and then tell their viewers it was live. They'd say it was live later and even have it taped. This is how they game things. And so the fact that people now, when they get interviewed for a documentary or for CNN or Fox or whatever it is, they record it, then the interview comes out and they show what really happened, and it'll destroy these dirty, slimy people's so-called careers because they deserve to be destroyed because they're deceivers of the people. And they're deceiving people to take a basic right hard fought for. And so I call it the New World Order's Brian Williams moment, Hillary Clinton's Brian Williams moment, Katie Couric's Brian Williams moment. They are the Brian Williams media, a bunch of lying, fake garbage with stolen glory, telling you things that are completely and totally, utterly untrue and are scientists of deception. Remember Gruber 4 years ago, 3 years ago, saying on all those C-SPAN videos, thank God the American people are so stupid. I was brought into double and triple prices for the insurance companies and rip them off. And he'd sit there at universities with PhDs and with other professors nodding and worshiping. Oh, we can be liars too. See, that's the new economy, is lying and deceiving. It's always been there. But now these guys get out in the open and lie to everyone. And then tell us that they're producing something and they're great people. Katie Couric is a predator. Katie Couric literally wants to deceive you. And I know most of you know that, but we should not just let them sit up there and lie. We should destroy them because they're trying to destroy us, is my point. And that's what Trump's doing when they're like, you know, he gets millions of dollars raised. He had 6 million pledged a few months ago. It finally all came in. People pledged, sir, I'm going to give a million. I'm going to give a half million. I'm going to give 100,000. All these business money knows. He marks it down in his book. He goes, we have 6 million pledged. Remember when he was winning those primaries? The media goes, he didn't really get 6 million. He just lied to you. And he goes, I said pledged. Well, he has the event. 6 million's come in. And they go, you didn't have it. You lied. See, they try to take truthfulness as if it's a lie, and then they take the lie and sell it as if it's the truth is what I'm getting at. And he just goes, you're a sleaze, ABC reporter. You're a sleaze. You're a liar. You're pathetic. He goes, okay, let's call these veterans groups up. How much money did I give you that was collected? 100%. Most charities keep 60, 70%. 100%. But see, they can turn Trump matching people's funds 100%, giving millions of dollars himself. They can turn that into a bad thing. But you know what? They can't do that anymore. So Pastor Manning joins us. We're going to cover a lot of news in this hour with him today. Pastor Manning of Atlah, A-T-L-A-H.org. And he is a prominent pastor. He's been speaking out against Obama from before he was even elected, warning of the great evil. I thought he was not exaggerating, but I thought he was miscalculating how bad it would be. I was wrong. It's far worse than I thought. It's been dead on. He has waged war against Christians. He is a wicked devil. And he's being opposed by folks right there in Harlem, like Pastor Manning, who also called for the boycott and the kicking of Sharpton off of MSNBC. That happened. So he's got a lot of courage because, let me tell you, the kingpin in Harlem, at least for 30 years, has been Al Sharpton. So to take on a kingpin in New York is a big deal. So I admire Pastor James David Manning for his courage. Atlah, A-T-L-A-H.org. So God bless you, my friend. You heard my little five-minute intro here. Do you think do you get my point of we need to punish these media whores and go after them and bring them down so the other liars know they're not safe?
Of course. And in fact, Alex, what you're saying with respect to Donald Trump's natural instinct to be truthful, to be powerful, to be fearless, that's natural for him. He doesn't have to think about that. He doesn't have to have poll people in the polls or premeditate what he's going to do. But you know, the other thing, there's a scientific axiom that says for every action, there's an opposite and equal reaction. And that is true as well. As a result of Donald Trump's natural instinct to be powerful, to be truthful, to be fearless, it brings out the natural instinct of the media to be sleazy, to be skanks, to be liars, to be dishonest, to be deceitful. That's just the opposite reaction that they have to Trump. Now, you notice, if there's someone else, I don't know, is it Hillary Clinton or Bill Clinton or whoever the hell else that comes on, they treat them differently because their natural reaction is different. But with Trump, the media is just getting worse. And the stronger he gets, the more, I suppose, skanky or sleazy they become. So that's why that's happening as that is. And it's going to continue in that mode as well, as long as Trump is in the public spotlight.
You targeted Sharpton, and he and deservedly have really crippled him. I'd say he's 80% fallen. He deserves it. We're going after Williams, Couric, all these folks, not in a vindictive way. These are lying predators squatting on us.
Right.
And if we just start going after them, they always fall.
Hello? Are you there?
Yes, Pastor. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Sorry, Skype blipped out. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, you're right. We need to go after them. We went after Sharpton. And let me say that we went after him, and God took him down. Listen, Alex, Sharpton had a 6 o'clock spot on MSNBC, drive time, people just getting home, watching the news for more than 3.5 years. We went after him. We went down to MSNBC and stood in front of the studio there at Rockefeller Center. For 8 hours, we stood in front of that studio and called Sharpton out. He wouldn't come out. In fact, all the other reporters that worked for MSNBC went in another door. We found out exactly what door they go into when they're going in to report for duty. Anyway, he came down. God took him down. We shut down a local restaurant. It was a very powerful restaurant here in New York City. We went before that restaurant one Sunday afternoon with our people out in front of that restaurant telling them that they're advertising on Sharpton's broadcast. And we were there for 15 minutes, a hot 15 minutes. The manager, who was in someplace else, owner of the restaurant, called us in and said, they'll never advertise on MSNBC again. He's gone. He's now at 8 o'clock on Sunday morning. There's nobody watching him now. It's just a matter of time now before he completely fades.
Sure, they say face. That's what they did with that Piers Morgan guy.
Yeah, right. They gave him that, but he's gone. He's through. But we need to, I mean, you're going after Katie Couric. She needs to be going after. The truth of the matter is there's nothing left there. She's hanging on by a wing in the press. She's not entertaining. She's certainly not a good journalist.
Yeah, she makes fraudulent documentaries now.
Yeah, but you know, the other thing you were talking about how CNN, I've watched you on CNN on several times, and how they manipulate your presence there. But I was amazed that you were able to satellite broadcast, bring your own camera in to CNN, because, you know, they're very strict about that kind of thing. But I've watched them, how they manipulate. And they, too, by the way, Alex, have a sense of evil, have a sense of lying and a sense of deception. We got to reach the people that watch CNN and let them know what's being done to them, that they're being brainwashed, that they're allowing.
That's a great point. There's still a remnant of people that buy into mainstream media. Now, the general public's still somewhat asleep, too, but they get their propaganda from entertainment and things that are embedded in media. That's why Obama goes on every show under the sun, from ESPN to Jimmy Fallon. How do we reach those people that are still in Zombo land, Pastor Manning?
Well, you know, we got to continue to do what we're doing. But I think one of the great ways that I reach them here is by stirring up the truth here in Harlem. I get the attention of the New York Times, and a lot of these people are New York Times readers or the CNN people. They're in that liberal mode. There is nothing too aggressive. But when you actually confront them with the truth, such as what I do, confronting black people, and it may be something that perhaps I can do, because I'm able to confront black people in Harlem. I'm able to tell them the truth. I'm able to tell them about themselves, about their EBT cards, about their track phones, about their so-called black president. That gets the media stirred to the point where they come to talk to me. And that way I can get these same people that listen to CNN, watch CNN, and get a little sentiments of truth in, if you will, a piece of truth. But it's very difficult because they're insulated. And they've got the media coverage, so they don't let persons like yourself get to them. But we can get them.
Sure. And just to clarify, I would say that I'm not doing the interview unless I can have my own camera person there. I would then record what was really said. They would try to distort it later, and I would show what was really said.
All right.
And so then they just stop interviewing me. Like you said, they're very controlling, period. And for years, I wasn't on until they agreed to have me live with Piers Morgan, and they cut that short as well. So that's why they never let me on live. Because they want to act like it's live with the host, taped an hour before, edit it however they want, cut your audio off, play games, and try to make it look like you said things you didn't say.
You know, I saw a clip, I think it was on CNN a week or so ago, it was on MSNBC, where they were talking about how Trump was on your broadcast and how you and trying to align Trump with being off the charts or loose cannon because he talks to Alex Jones. I was sitting there watching it, and that's exactly, I think it was MSNBC, Chris Matthews, you know that creep, that lowlife.
It's all
Chris
over. Matthews. Yeah, Slimeball is his name.
Yeah, it's okay.
Slimeball. He hosts the show Slimeball.
Yeah, okay, all right. But he's the one who said it. Oh, Trump, he talks to loose cannons like Alex Jones. Had your picture up there and had you, I mean, he stayed on you for a while. And the other little guy that comes on after him went after you as well. I said, why are they trying to skew Alex here?
Because
tonight?
They know if Trump goes with hardcore Americana, he will win. They're trying to manipulate his campaign people to buy into the fact that, oh, don't go in the briar patch. And of course, Trump's smart. He's jumping in the briar patch because he knows that's where the populism is. Listen, behind the scenes.
They may be thinking as well, Alex, that if Trump wins, which I think he's going to do, that's going to elevate your position to reach a lot of people because Trump is going to come to you.
You're right. The New York Times actually said that last week. They said it's horrible. Alex Jones.
And they're afraid of you. It's not Trump. They are afraid of Trump. But they will be afraid of your influence.
And you too. It's just everybody that's straight talking. That's all we're doing. But the New York Times actually said that. They said the horror of Alex Jones being elevated and legitimate. And they said it appears it's already happened.
Right. Right.
Absolutely. I mean, the whole Pentagon listens. Of course it already happened.
Absolutely. So that's the thing they're afraid of. And I think that's the thing that needs to happen in America. You know, it has been reported throughout history that, you know, you rise, you fall, you go up, you go down. Kingdoms come and kingdoms fall. And it's
their era is ending. Their era is ending. Is that what you're saying?
That's all I'm trying to say. That's exactly what I'm
saying. So what's coming, my friend?
Well, I think persons such as yourself are coming, and modestly, I'd like to think that I'm coming as well. Modestly, I'd like to say. But to be sure, persons like yourself are coming. Drudge needs more exposure as well, because they beat Drudge down. We need Breitbart out there more effectively as well. And I think once we get that kind of an American patriotic, if you will, with a godly Christian base, dealing with America again, we can see America. In fact, Trump is going to need you, Breitbart and Drudge, to make America great again. Hell, the New York Times is not going to help him. Wall Street Journal, Washington Post, they're not going to help him. So he's going to need people
like
that.
Sure, if they endorse him, that will hurt him. And they're just now figuring out 6% of the public trust mainstream media. But getting aside Alex Jones or Matt Drudge, because we're all in this fight like you to fight tyranny, we're just manifestations, our growing success. And the establishment's fear that they have no credibility. It's not that we're that good. It's that they're that bad. As you said earlier, Trump just naturally, somebody charges the stage, he runs at him. Somebody gets in his face and lies about him. He says, you're a piece of garbage liar. You know, they're so scared of the fact. But then when they get around evil people like Hillary or Obama or Michael Moore, they all just fawn over each other. In fact, I know two people that know the heir to the Astor fortune, tens of billions of dollars, folks, in hidden assets and things like that. CIA operative Anderson Cooper. Folks, look it up. He's really CIA and disinformation operative.
His mother's Gloria Vanderbilt. You know who his mother is? Gloria Vanderbilt. That's who his mother was. I think she's deceased now.
Absolutely. So he's the heir to that. And I know multiple people that know him, and I'm going to stop there. He had a driver for 3 years that he never talk to, and people that work for him are told, don't look him in the eye. He doesn't give people bonuses reportedly. And it's the same with Hillary and all of them. These people don't, like Hillary, they don't pay their taxes. They steal money from charities. I'm talking about Hillary now. You can't look him in the eye. They're the most hateful, anti-liberal people on earth. And they sit up there telling us all day how they love us and how they love America and how they're the moral authority when he's a guy worth billions and billions of dollars in tax-free foundations in the CIA attacking America and won't even talk to his driver or his butler for 3 years, sir.
Exactly. What you have just said is the reason why the media is attacking Trump the way they're attacking him, because they recognize a Trump presidency. Forget about a Trump presidency.
And he treats his employees super good and is super real. That's what they're scared of.
Let's just look at a Trump candidacy, how the Trump candidacy is revealing all the things you've just said about the billions of, not millions, but billions of dollars are being stolen. The fact that they don't pay taxes, the fact that the CIA becomes their own protective security agency, and how they, if you will, propagandize everything to the American people who are still asleep in their sofas, riding around in their Silverados and not paying attention to what the hell is going on. That's what a Trump candidacy has done. Imagine what a Trump presidency will do.
Exactly. But getting off on that rant, when you talk about Henry Kissinger, Hillary, Michael Moore, any of them, I've seen them personally around their people. They treat their people like they're not human. You're not supposed to look them in the eyes. These are monstrous people. How could you have a driver for 3 years? I mean, I'd be my driver. I mean, I don't have a driver, but I have a driver. They'd be my best friend probably in a month or something. I just don't get how you can be around people and then...
You said something a few moments ago early on in your first segment about demonizing, and then you went on to explain that in a great way, that you're referencing that they're demonizing or that they have demons, rather, because they are demonizing, which makes a whole lot of sense. I forgot exactly how you said it, and I kind of let it get
past. Well, we have to demonize them because they are out coming after us acting like demons. They are demons, so when we expose them, we're demonizing them because they are demons.
So when you talk about people like Henry Kissinger and Bill Clinton and all the rest of that crowd you just made mention of, these people are high into demon possession. They just are. Listen, Alex, you cannot reach the level of debauchery and evil that they are in and still be a Sunday school student. You just can't do it. It is required. It is a requirement that you have a certain amount of demonic power
to be part of the club. You got to be bad things.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. So, yeah, so they got to be demon inspired to do what they do. And we need to maybe, you know, but they present this facade to the people. The press then inculcates that facade to make people think that out there that's just watching in their easy chair, that these are normal people that have just worked very hard to become who the hell they are. That's not true at all. It's just the opposite of that.
They've been led into a evil society. It's a spirit. They've been led into a cult of no name, a cult of predators.
I mean, you think about the Skull and Bones Society, which all the Bushes belong to, the Yale students all participate in, where you lie in a coffin and people come by and urinate on you. You know, you can think about what does that do to a person's psyche, and where do you have to be in order to want to be a part of that? And then once you get out of that soap, that piss-soaked coffin, what are you willing to do or say or be if you allow yourself to do that or participate in such? I'd never let another man piss on me while I'm lying.
And by the way, that's only the first level of it. It goes right into hardcore stuff later.
I'm glad you pointed that up. But yeah, that's what we're dealing with in America. Alex, and you know, as you stated earlier, we're not that good at what we do. I mean, okay, we might know something about broadcasting, but it's just that what they do is so obviously evil. And thank God some of us have the ability to look and to see what they're doing. And I, you know, I want to thank God for your audience too, Alex. I think you have to give them credit that they're able to hear you.
They're amazing.
Yeah, because listen, I mean, can you imagine how your audience, people that listen to you all over the world, but especially in America, are bombarded by their coworkers, bombarded by the liberal media, bombarded by the politicians to try
but
to
they
get
break
to
the bullying. The bullying doesn't control them. I want to ask you, because I agree with you, another great turning's coming. They know a time of great change is coming. They're trying to stop that. What do you expect to see in the future? What will Obama do? What are you watching on your radar? Pastor Manning is our guest, Otla.org. I'm Alex Jones of Infowars.com. Stay with us. You know, our founders in this country were predominantly Christians. They were predominantly Protestants. Nothing against Catholics. I don't get into that whole bash fest. But they really wanted to build a free world, and they tried to end the evils of slavery in Europe. And England finally did end it, and ended it worldwide, put ships on the seas for 50 years to kill anybody that was running slaves. And then America tried to end it in 1776, but couldn't. And we ended up having a horrible civil war that killed over 1 million people. But you notice in the modern age, they always pointed America's evils, but not that slavery's going on in the Middle East right now. The women are slaves. And I raise that point every day because they're demonizing the idea of Christ illuminating us. You go, well, Illuminati, that's Illuminati. No, the globalists saw our revolution, the Jacobins, they created the French Revolution. They created a counterfeit to the Christians that wanted to bring light to the world, who wanted to truly build a new world. They knew they couldn't end all that corruption in that system. They tried to set up a new one, and it wasn't perfect either, but it had the idea to reach for something better. And that's why you only hear about the sins of America or the West, because the globalists are against that, because they want to go back to tyranny, back to older and Western tyranny, similar to what Rome had. Absolute rule, absolute control. And that's where we're going today. And I simply don't like seeing people oppressed or controlled. And I see the social justice warriors. I'm going to ask Pastor Manning about this in a moment. We have like, it's got to be 15, 20 videos or more. New ones are going up every 10 minutes. Biggs is just doing a great job by himself. We didn't have the crew. We're short on crew right now because folks are on vacation. And he wanted to go out to California to follow the social justice warriors at universities where any libertarians or Christians or conservatives speak, they come to shut it down. or even folks that are concerned about liberals are putting this on. I'd call the guy part liberal from Breitbart, their tech editor, who is, you know, against them trying to ban free speech, even though he is AKA a homosexual. They don't even want to let him speak. So these people are anti-free speech. And I think that's going to be their answer to the new enlightenment, the new renaissance of awakening and empowerment that we're starting to see happen worldwide, because things got to get bad before they get better. We're going to talk to Pastor Manning here in just a moment. I want to have your quick questions or comments for Pastor Manning here in about 10 minutes, 800-259-9231. So I want to get a bunch of you on, 800-259-9231. Pastor Manning will be with us about 5 after next hour. Then Joe Biggs is going to be joining us from the ground in the middle of this. He's already been to 2 universities. It's total bedlam. These people are attacking, screaming racist. They're mainly white people. Screaming, you're a white male, you're not allowed to speak. I mean, it is the most bizarre stuff you've ever seen. It's like that Guardian guy that is, you know, saying that whites are inherently evil, and the guy looks like he's like 80% Anglo. It's just a reverse mental illness racism. I want to ask Pastor Manning what he calls it. I call it divide and conquer, but we're going to be talking about that in just a minute. Now, briefly, we are listener supported. I'm going to leave it at that. So is Pastor Manning with his broadcast, what he does, feeding hundreds of children and youth a day, really waking up Harlem. He's a great place for you to support as well. He didn't pay me to say that. I get guests on I admire and I appreciate, and that I think you ought to know about. It's hard for me to find good churches to tithe to. I do give the Salvation Army and to some small country churches and things, but most of these big mega churches are just sold out to make everybody feel good and not stand, you know. Find a church that goes and protests abortion clinics. That's where you ought to be giving money. Or a place that feeds poor people. Or a place that goes and gets bums off the street and tries to rehabilitate them. You know, that's what this comes down to. And he's doing it. So Otla.org, I think folks should support him. If you really want to bring some light to Harlem, and he's already brought a lot of light with his great congregation. They're very exciting. And we need to be supported. And our local affiliates need to be supported. We have the new Alexa Pure Breeze, energy efficient HEPA ion cluster air purification system. This is the highest rated. There are similar units that are upwards of $1,000. This is normally 200 and something bucks. It's 184 introductory offer, 4-stage purification process for superior air quality. Patented ion cluster technology kills airborne microbes with a final byproduct of clean water, no ozone. That's good, because a lot of those ozone machines are toxic in my view. I mean, I know when something making me feel sick. Intelligent air quality sensor and indicators. Easy to clean and maintain. Silent mode, 16 dB, quieter than the whisper. Energy efficient, cycles 120 feet every 12 minutes. Air change per hour. ACH exceeds allergy and asthma foundation recommendations. Space-saving design, about the size of a large briefcase. Perfect for rooms up to 800 square feet. One purification unit with ion cluster technology. One pre-filter. One true HEPA filter. One carbon-activated filter. And these last a long time. You can also clean them. We have a breakdown of them up against leading competitors. It's just amazing, the innovation. We only bring in the very best sponsors. We direct sell this to you from the manufacturer in Utah. They're patriots, so it's a win-win-win. Support the show. Support American industry. Support your family. Infowarsstore.com. And I'd buy one of these for every room. Just buy one, see if you like it, and then get more. It's truly amazing. They make great water filters, Alexa Pure as well, 10% off of promo code WATER. And we've got a lot of other great products at InfoWarsLife.com. BrainForce is an amazing nootropic, totally natural, and just boosts normal brain activity. Quite frankly, it's so powerful, I only take it if I've got to work at night. I mean, I've had one cup of coffee today, and I'm bouncing off the walls. So I don't need more energy with Super Male Vitality and X2. But if you want to kick in the pants, this is it. It's like my buddy took. He took 3 knockouts last night, and he could hardly get up this morning. So when you take our sleep aid, I wouldn't take more than 2, folks. Anthroplex is back in stock. It's basically like the powder version, lower price but high quality of Supermel Vitality. Secret 12 is the highest quality methylcobalamin vitamin B12. That's available at InfoWarsLife.com as well. So thank you so much again for joining us. I don't do a plug every segment like most hosts. I do like a 5-minute plug each hour. And please support us, because you are what allows us to continue on. And we're all in this together. And I want to thank you all and salute you all for your support, your prayers, most importantly. And then, of course, spreading the word about the broadcast. They're trying to censor us. They're globally announcing censorship. And that's what I want to turn to now. They have somehow taken liberals who had a lot of good ideas about empowering everybody, giving everybody a shot. They just stole the Christian ethic of the abolitionist. That wasn't just here. That was in Europe. And that's what happened. And they just turned it into a social justice warrior thing now, where they want to get rid of speech and the right of assembly and Christians' rights in the name of total equality. Now you can't say mother or father on government forums or say it in school, literally, because that might hurt somebody who doesn't have a mother or father. See, now you can't have something because somebody else doesn't have it. This is going into pure communism. All the elite are offshore and, you know, have billions of dollars and red carpets. It's so hypocritical. But they're also promoting globally with Facebook and others, with the EU, to start just don't criticize Islam. We're going to arrest you or kick you off Facebook. The global initiative to censor is now here because they want to hold back humanity wanting choice, wanting true diversity, wanting the power to discriminate. Yeah, it's wrong to discriminate against somebody just because they're a woman or they're a man or they're white or they're black or whatever. But to say I go to this restaurant because their food's better than the other restaurant where I get food poisoning, that's discrimination. If you're walking down the street and there's potholes and you step over one so you don't get your shoes wet, that's discrimination. If you hire somebody and you catch them stealing a day after, discrimination is just knowing what's going on. So they've twisted words, and I think we're going to see a huge reign of censorship. My response is don't give into it. But Pastor Manning, you've got the floor the next 10 minutes or so before we go to calls. Correct me if I'm wrong. Augment that. Take your time. Walk through how you think they're going to counterstrike this huge global awakening that's happening, sir.
But a couple of things, Alex. I think that we need to be very mindful of a post-Obama era. And one of the things that I've noticed about the recent activities of Obama, number one, was that he, the first of a president to visit some maximum security prisons and to begin to hammer the judges, the Supreme Courts, and the federal courts to release their sentence practices on prisoners and to try to reverse some of the sentences that have already been handed down, given the opportunity for many of these prisoners, people that are in prison, that are inculcated with Islam, because black men that go to prison learn about Islam. It's very pervasive in the prisons, but also black men that go to prison and white folk, they are very inculcated with the whole idea of hating America. And they already had before going to prison to become criminals, they had a warped sense of what is right and what is wrong and a warped sense of justice. I'm very concerned now as well that the movie industry has all of a sudden released a remake of the 1970s edition of the 8-segment movie of Roots that stirred the hearts of young men, that sent men to prison in large numbers. Roots, as a documentary declaring that it was authentic, demonstrating the horrific or alleged horrific events that happened to black people with the slave trade, where most of the slave trade went on in Africa with blacks on blacks, that haven't been said, that I see a storm coming with the releasing of Roots.
Oh, the media is hyping race war 24/7 everywhere.
Yeah, well,
and no one's defending European slavery. But exactly, no one talks about that. Everybody's done it. It's wrong. It's evil. Humans are wicked. We should repent. But they are just hyping it. What's going on?
Well, I think that we're going to see the release of a lot of prisoners, and I think that most Americans are locked and loaded and ready to deal with whatever come down
the pipe. I was about to ask you, what do you think this move by Obama? Because obviously there's a lot of nonviolent people in prison that should be let out. But what about this push to let violent felons out? What's behind that?
Because I think that he wants to return to a period of the 1960s, the 60s and the 70s, where the Black Panthers were the Mau Maus, where black liberation groups, if you will, were very prevalent. That mindset is still locked away in prison. What you have today with the rappers, young black men that are rappers and wear their pants below their butts, they don't have that kind of mindset and hatred against America. I think that Obama's setting up preachers to come back from the prisons and reignite the communities. And I would say anybody living within 100 to 150 miles of a major urban area need to get prepared to see the riot, and if anything goes amiss or awry with Obama or somehow another Obama or something done to Obama's political ideas, such as the removal of Obamacare. I mean, listen, Alex, if Trump or anyone else were to take down Obamacare and it effectively goes away, You can see these people coming from prison now training young men who now wear their pants below their butts, rapping but really having no teeth, now beginning to look like the 60s, the mid-60s, and the early 70s when it comes to
Yeah, so the Viacom CIA-run weapon system is activating the Beyoncés and all the rest of the folks to, you know, say, go out and kill the pigs.
Yeah, so but not just pigs, but people that are part. For instance, if you are a part of the whole idea that
Obama and that'll cause a giant counter oppression of black people just trying to, you know, live the American dream.
Absolutely. So I cannot imagine that this is not going to take place. I can't see how it. I don't think Obama would have gone to the prisons unless he wanted to indicate to judges everywhere, and most of the federal and state judges are very liberal. And if Obama says that the system, the penal system has been oppressive, you're going to see cases coming back before the courts. You're going to see parole officers releasing people who normally would be kept in prison.
And they're going to make room for the libertarians, the patriots, the Christians, who they're now throwing the book at as the new enemy.
Absolutely. So I think we need to be very mindful of this. And we need to be mindful of this catalyst now being released in this Roots presentation. It's not good, Alex. It's not good for America.
And we have new listeners. Obama, the Justice Department announced last month that they're moving to basically tell judges and others, we're going to prosecute you or come after prosecutors if you don't let people off or let folks out of prison. And right. Again, these are mainly violent folks they're talking about. I'm all for letting nonviolent people out. But no, they're saying, period, just start letting people out.
Absolutely, because I think Obama wants to have a different kind of a brown shirts, if you remember that, from back in 2008 and 2009, militia, rather than what the initial idea of brown shirts all about. I can't imagine Obama walking away from power, Alex. I can't imagine. I've told you this 8 years ago.
So you think letting the prisoners out like the Soviets and like the Nazis, when the Nazis took over, they released all the people out of the prisons that were aligned with the National Socialist, hundreds of thousands of them, and put them in charge.
Listen, when Castro released the prisoners during the Mariel boat lift from Cuba, they all flooded into Miami, into Florida, and then across over to Texas. That was the real start of the major drug problems in America, because those, and many of them were psychopaths that came out of the prisons in Cuba. So I think that what we see happening, Alex, I just can't imagine Obama walking away from power and riding off into the sunset when he knows right now he's got the courts, he's got the Supreme Court, he's got the judges, he's got the politicians, he's got the media in his hands. Why should he walk away and say, well, I had my 8 years, I
agree with you. He might try something. They're so bold. Who knows?
He's going to try something. No, he's going to. No, he's already put it in the works. I mean, remember, Obama is CIA. Understand that. He is a compadre.
His whole family,
Yeah, he's a compadre with Putin and Russia. He's not going to walk away from world power. He just isn't going to. And anybody who thinks that he does. Now, I'm all for Trump. And you know I am. I'm all in on Trump. But anybody who thinks that Obama's going to walk away from power, you're not thinking. You're just not thinking.
Let me play this clip, the chilling clip about the National Security Force, where they want to make everybody serve 3 years out of high school as domestic political police, social justice warriors with badges, with guns. By the third year, they can graduate and get the badges and get the guns. And it's already happening with federal police and others. They're arming every agency and hiring social justice warrior types. Let's play the clip.
We cannot continue to rely only on our military in order to achieve the national security objectives that we've set. We've got to have a civilian national security force that's just as powerful, just as strong, just as well-funded.
I mean, this is chilling what they're doing. So, sir, you've studied it. You're in the middle of it. You were right about Obama more than I was, how dangerous he'd be. I hate the Republicans so much that I was kind of neutral the first election. I'm actually embarrassed about that. I didn't support him, but I just couldn't. Bush was so bad. Who knows? Obama would be three times worse.
I can understand that. I can understand not supporting Bush, but go ahead. I'm sorry.
No. Just in the one that we have before break, what else is Obama going to pull then?
Well, I think he's going to continue to exercise his powers no matter who goes into office. He's put everything in place as any reasonably person, thinking person would do, except for idiots like Bush. And I think that Bush initially thought that by putting Obama in power as president, because, you know, Bush had the opportunity to stop Obama's presidency.
Sure, he did, yeah.
He had the CIA report. George Tenet had all the information.
He let the economy slide. He even helped Obama get in.
Absolutely, absolutely. So I think Obama has, what I see, more of a race war coming like we've never seen before.
But you know, more and more, has Obama double-crossed even the establishment? Is that what you're saying?
I know he's double-crossed black people, and he's getting ready to do it again. But they love it, Alex. Like, you can't talk to them. They love it. But he's getting ready to double-cross them again.
We'll be back with your phone call. Stay with us, Pastor. The American people of every color really just want to be friends with each other. But no, the media won't let it rest. They just hype it and push it and drive it. Joe Biggs, there's been a shooting outside UCLA in California. Joe Biggs is right by it. He's going to probably have a live feed coming up in the next segment with us. He's going to get on early with us. He's on at the bottom of the hour. He's out there covering social justice warriors foaming at the mouth. I want to go to Michael in Louisiana, AJ in Ohio, Joseph in New York, Ed in California. The caller I was about to go to just hung up on line two. They had a really good question. About economic collapse. But another person, AJ, has the same question, because that's what I'm concerned about. I mean, when the Royal Bank of Scotland says sell everything that's paper and the elites are getting armored redoubts, I mean, it's all over the news now. I'm hoping things don't collapse, but I mean, this bubble's so big. AJ, you're on the air. Go ahead and talk to Pastor Manning of OTLA.
Yeah, hi, Pastor Manning. Love you to death. And that's hey, a white AJ. Man telling you that. I know it's politically incorrect, but
it's okay. I'll let it slide. Go ahead.
Anyhow, my friend. I'm having a hard time seeing Obama actually leaving the presidency. I think he has lots of weapons in his toolbox, and I think one of them would definitely be an engineered collapse of the economy. I just kind of wanted to get your thoughts on that because
absolutely. I think collapse is his big ace in the hole. What do you think?
Well, I agree with you 100% that he's not going to leave power. If he may possibly officially leave the office, but he's not going to leave power. And if he doesn't,
you mean
leave
put in
power,
all his people? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he's already got the deck stacked everywhere as to how he will manipulate America and the world. He's got the globalists at, he's at their beck and call. An economic collapse is the best way. You can always manipulate people when you can take food off the table and off the shelves of the supermarkets, and you can devalue everything that people have.
And seize their bank accounts.
Yeah. So I think economic collapse, it will be better than a race war. That's not going to be very effective. It will, of course, ignite some concerns. But you're right. On both counts, one, he's not going to leave power. And two, he's going to use an economic collapse. And though we all love Donald Trump and want to see him in power, we're looking at a very dark future for America. Very, very dark.
Great question, AJ. Anything else?
Real quick. I know it's a little off the subject, but I had this dry cough for months, and I bought your lung cleanse, and not to get too graphic, but let's just say it cleared things up very well. So great product. Thank you very much, Alex.
Thank you. It's just a whole bunch of known concentrated herbs. The problem is it's so oily, you got to keep the spout clean under hot water because it clogs, because it's just a whole bunch of essential oils concentrated. Most lung stuff is just a couple sprays and some feel-good stuff. Doesn't really help you. I mean, we sound to make something really good. So thank you for the plug. Lung cleanse is amazing. InfoWarsLife.com. Thank you, AJ. Let's get one more call as we go to break here and do one more segment with Pastor Manning before he does his own broadcast. Let's talk to Ed in California. You're on the air. Go ahead, Ed.
Good morning, gentlemen. Alex, thanks for the show. Thanks for waking me up. Pastor Manny, I didn't call to start an argument or pick on you. I'm a black American. I work hard every day. I have a family with a sort of strong, proud history in America. And a lot of times when I watch your OTLA broadcast, you're very negative toward black people. I just want to know, why do you do that? Or why do I have that perception of you, perhaps?
It could largely be your perception, but I can tell you there is some meat to what you're perceiving. Mainly because you have to get black folks' attention. Listen, I live in Harlem, and I've been black for a goodly number of years. I have seen socially, politically, religiously, what black folk have done. When you're living in the midst of a community where 90% of the households are headed by women and men have no sense of responsibility, when you see children that are hungry and cold and are poor, you can only speak that as a truth. And to a lot of people, it seems very hard.
I was about to say, Pastor Manning, stay there. Come back and have the floor on this. We'll go back to the caller. But I want you to be able to speak on this because it's called tough love, folks. I mean, it's like if an alcoholic is drinking two bottles of vodka a day, you got to tell him to stop it. We'll be back. Stay with us. Pastor Manning is our guest. I love humanity. In my gut, I'm a God-fearing person. No matter how much propaganda is out there, no matter how bad people treat me because of what color I am in my life. I know in my gut and my heart that if I start hating children of any color, that I basically forfeited my soul. I just feel it. I love humanity. And it's a total setup where they play us off against each other. It's all divide and conquer. And when they sit there and have black liberation theology in the prisons, that's all Ford Foundation, CIA run, that's declassified. It's to make sure people are mentally crippled. They come out, they're controlled by those groups. They won't integrate or work with anybody else or be happy. Then that makes whites get paranoid and be even more racist because that's going on the other side. Then you have a little mini race war, and then black people get even more suppressed. Blacks are, what, 30% of the population, half that's men, you know, 6.5%. And you're going to get in a fight with all the, you know, honkies that are armed to the teeth and, you know how to go run around the world killing everybody. I mean, that is just not a good move. And that's what they're setting up. That's what they're pushing. And then Pastor Manning's over here saying, let's not do this. Let's be Christian. Let's get jobs. Let's build our communities. Let's have men in the homes. And that's called not liking black people. I don't know what broadcast Ed's listening to, but I hear somebody who loves humanity and loves his people. Now, I'm going to go back to Ed in a minute, but Manning, is that accurate what I said?
Oh, it's absolutely spot on. I mean, we've had 70 years of panty waste policies and activities towards black people, obfuscating their responsibility, allowing them to think and to do and tell them how bad the world has treated them. And look at where
how
it's
do you make
us.
Somebody strong weak? You pamper them so they are weak. That was a total attack.
Absolutely. And it was a planned attack as well. So we have to realize that, you know, Harry Truman said when he was president, they used to call him "Give 'em Hell, Harry." And the president Harry said, "I don't give 'em hell. I just tell them the truth, and they think it's hell." You know, when you've got a society of people who are at the bottom of the world's social register, and there's no denying that. I didn't put black people at the bottom of the economic ladder. I didn't put them at the bottom of the family ladder. I didn't put them at the bottom of every social remedy. I didn't put them there. They are there. How do you get them out? You don't get them out by telling them it's okay for them to stay the hell there.
Adversity makes men. Prosperity makes monsters. That's Victor Hugo.
And so we have got to be able to tell people, listen, you know, here's the truth. You need to go back to leadership of your home. You need to go back to taking care of your family and your church. And you need to realize that all of the so-called leaders over the last 60 years have made the conditions. I mean, look at Chicago. You got Louis Farrakhan living in Chicago. You got Obama claiming to come from Chicago. You've got Jesse Jackson. You got three of the black greatest leaders in Chicago. Yet you've got, and they are the ones who are panty-wasting black men. Yet they've got more killings of black people in Chicago than we have any place else. Does Albert, whoever he is, want me to have the same kind of rhetoric that Jesse Jackson, Louis Farrakhan, and Obama has for black men?
Well, sure, I'm not defending Farrakhan's compendium of work, but Jackson and others do want the liberal social stuff. I mean, Farrakhan at least tries to get folks to get jobs and have their own business.
No, he does. No, I have to give him credit for that. He does. He understands that is the way in which we must go. But I think that when I live in Harlem, and I see the suffering. I'm a pastor of women who've got no man in their life. They go to bed lonely and cold every night. I'm the pastor of children who don't know who their fathers are. I see this go on and on.
I know you do.
And I see politicians get up and talk about how bad the white man is. Hell, listen, you can take care of your children. I don't care what the circumstances are. Be a father. Work two jobs, three jobs. What's wrong with that?
I know, it's incredible. I'm telling this, these men are just, they think being lazy, I'm about white men, Hispanics, you name it, they think laying around's fun. A man busts his ass.
Absolutely, absolutely. You defend your children with your life. And I think if we had more of that kind of a spirit, more of that spirit, we wouldn't see.
Well, Pastor people. Manning, I always feel like I've had a big old drink of cold water on a hot day when you've been on. You're a great patriot. I love your spirit. Otlet.org.
Alex, thank you so very much. It's a big honor.
Thank
man.
You. That's big honor to have. We now take you live to the highway between San Diego and Los Angeles at UCLA as Joe Biggs follows a phalanx of police cars. We can put up Fox, CNN, you name it. It looks like 500 cops, different agencies, LAPD, you name it, just standing around waiting to raid UCLA and to find out, as we cover the media covering the media here, what's going on. So two victims, and it's like the end of the world. And I'm sad somebody got shot, but Most of the time it's gang related, which just shows that's part of, you know, the whole drug culture. And if, you know, two people die in a bus accident, nobody cares. But if it's guns, it's the end of the world. Truth is, gun crime is down over 20 years. Mass shootings are flat. But we'll find out with Joe Biggs, who's been dealing with social justice warriors and following that whole tour that Breitbart's got, just going and having free speech events that they try to shut down everywhere to illustrate their tyranny. In fact, if I was running the Trump campaign, I'd be out in California every week just to show these people. Every time he does it, his poll numbers go up a point or two. I mean, to just to show the, how authoritarian these folks are. But another so-called mass shooting, which two people, two victims. Joe Biggs, you're driving there, joining us via Skype. Thank you. What intel do you have us?
Well, so far, it's confirmed, yeah, two people have been shot. They're saying they're still an active shooter. I'm on the 405 right now, speeding as fast as I can, behind what seems to be about 50 to 80 cops that have passed me already. They're in the side lane. I'm in the passenger zone lane right now, driving up there as quickly as possible to get there. And as you know, I was actually on the UCLA campus last night, and I just spoke with Milo's manager. They had left and went outside and were talking to some friends and then decided to go back inside that building. And they actually had a bomb threat called on them. So now they're worried that if they continue on with the event today in Long Beach, that this could be related in some way. So they're trying to figure out what they want to do with Breitbart, if they still want to have this event. But, you know, last night I was inside the building where Milo was giving a speech, and there were these people outside the building banging and beating on the wall, screaming and yelling. You know, it was ridiculous. These people are insane.
So you're saying that they've been having bomb threats to shut down these events. That's newsworthy right there. And this could be related to that as a way to try to shut things down. I hope that the social justice warriors haven't shot someone. Is that what you're saying?
I don't know. I mean, I literally just got off the phone with Milo's manager, and they were worried about that because they were leaving, and then they decided to, they had some more friends show up later on. And they went back inside the building where they had the venue last night or whatever. And they said that the police got word that there was a bomb threat, and they were all told to evacuate, swept out of there. And now they're worried that this might be related in a way, so they might shut down this event that they were going to have at Long Beach today. So it's very interesting. This is, you know, very intense. I'm driving as fast as I can through tons of traffic on my right side that's at a standstill on the 405 heading north. So hopefully we can get there in time. We can find out what's going on.
Well, you're in the fast track behind the police. We'll get a video Skype feed as soon as you get there. How far out are you?
It looks like 3.5 miles away with traffic, about 13 minutes. So I'm getting closer. I've been on the road for a little bit now.
Take a break. We'll get you on 40 after or so once you can set up a video feed there on the ground. But that is certainly newsworthy. Please call in a report to Don Salazar, Kit Daniels, or Mikhail Thalen, or any of our reporters, Paul Watson's listening, to give us the basic facts, because, wow, the fact that there's been a bomb threat. Slowly go over it all one more time for our reporters and listeners, exactly where you've been, the tour you're on, what's happening, and what's unfolded.
Well, I'm on the free speech tour with Milo Yiannopoulos. He's a writer for Breitbart, and he's known for a lot of controversial statements. He says feminism is cancer. And I came out, I was invited by his manager to come cover a few of his events. He had three events in a row, last night UCLA, today Long Beach, and tomorrow UC Irvine, which is actually right beside Costa Mesa. We all saw that epic footage that our reporters got when they were down there covering the Trump event, and they're expecting a lot more like that to happen again as well at this UC Irvine event. So what happened last night when we were at the UCLA event, a lot of social justice warriors showed up, beating and banging on doors. They made a human chain with their arms interlinked. They were literally attacking and pushing people. And it was beyond anything I've seen at some of these. I mean, they were literally jumping in front of people and throwing themselves. I saw a girl jump and start backing into a guy, hitting him, a reporter, and then told the cops that he assaulted her. And then the cops basically were like, you know, talking to him like he was like some criminal.
That's what's crazy from Portland and upstate New York, everywhere. They'll have the social justice warriors, when you were there, hitting people, saying you're not allowed to have a Trump event with six people. And then the cops come and say, yes, we agree. You're not allowed. Good job beating them up. I mean, these cops are like whacked out loons.
Now there's ambulances coming, swerving out of the roads around me right now. Wow. this is intense. I mean, this place is everywhere. I mean, there's
total hysteria. They do this to demonize guns. Anytime there's a shooting or a banana peel on the ground, they make a huge deal out of it. Joe, I'm going to let you focus. We'll talk to you in about 20 minutes. Be safe.
Okay.
All right, there goes Joe Biggs. I got loaded phone lines. Pastor Manning left because I had Joe Biggs coming up. He was going to be there at the university, the site of the next event. Ladies and gentlemen, we need other patriots to go out because Joe will be in the midst of like 500 anti-American weirdo, whether they're black, white, Hispanic. They'll have like zits all over their face, drooling. They can hardly talk. A lot of them weigh like 400 pounds. I'm not being mad at fat people. It's just that it's like seems to be what they're into, you know, just sitting on their couch all day. Just screaming, no free speech, blah, blah, kill Trump, blah, you know, all this garbage. We need everybody to go to these events and just document it. Because we'll have people in a crowd and get incredible footage that gets, you know, 10 million views and is on Drudge and, you know, on CNN and Fox. But we're missing the real gold. I mean, so many times you got a camera and you miss just the most insane stuff you wish you'd have caught. I don't care if you put a Bernie shirt on and just go out there and infiltrate these groups. You could get the footage that is the meme that shoots the black arrow into the dragon's heart and brings it down. I mean, we're so close. This fight is so close right now. I cannot express to you how you need to be on the ground as boots on the ground. I just got chills. I just get chills. This is the battle for the Republic, folks. This is up against people that want to make us poor to control us. They want to blow the engine of free market. We're barely keeping the country going right now. We have had so many victories. We've had so many defeats. We're in a toe-to-toe death battle. And when you're out there taking action, when you're out there speaking out, when you're out there, even more importantly, getting intel on these brainwashed zombies that are the enemy. I feel sorry for them. They're idiots. They're dangerous, but they're like a zombie attack wave. I mean, they're still the enemy. You got to deal with them. And that's just the way it is, okay? So get out there. Just do it. Just get into their groups. Act like a hateful, anti-human piece of trash. And they'll start spewing, we're going to murder everybody. We're communists. Oh, God. I wish years ago I'd have caught on tape anarchists that are really communists coming up and telling me they're going to kill me and they're going to take over the country and stuff. I mean, I just, back then you didn't have phones to record or whatever. And I have a camera guy and he'd be 10 feet away when they do it. You know, they'd come over when nobody was watching. And punch you in the back, you know, and try to get you to physically attack them. They try all sorts of scams. And I'm just telling you, if the American people get up off the bench of every race, color, and creed, every stupid sexual persuasion, I don't care. Don't you believe in freedom? Don't you believe in the freedom of speech and property? I mean, that's why everybody wants to come here, because we have a little bit of freedom. Hell, we're a rat hole. We're a cesspit in many respects. But compared to other cesspits, we're looking pretty good right now. And just get off the bench, get up off the bench, get up off the stool, get up and just get in the fight. It's going to feel so good once you're in it. I remember so many times there'd be some bully flunk 3-4 grades waiting for me in junior high or high school. And they'd say, I'm going to be waiting right here. And you know what? I'd be walking out. My mom was there to pick me up, or I'd be taking the bus. And I'd say, you know what? I'm going to go on down there to that park. That guy thinks he weighs 50 pounds, 100 pounds more than me. He's beat up a whole string of folks. Because the weird thing about it was so fun to just march up to those people. No matter what they did to me, I was going to beat their ass in the end. And you know what? At the end of the day, they'd be sitting there on the ground, laid out, blood all over their face, their nose broken, their teeth loose. Everybody'd be going, look at that 13-year-old kid just beat up that 17-year-old bully. And I'd look at him and I'd say, that's how you get the job done right there. And that's living. And I'm here to tell people right now, you need to stop being cowards and stop being afraid of these people. It's time to take them on, because the fight isn't with schoolyard bullies here. It's with people that want to rape our rights, abort our children, chop their body parts up and sell them, and have this witch filth, Katie Couric, sit up there and edit videos like gun owners are a bunch of mentally retarded idiots. Sick of her crap. I salute Trump for going after that witch. Everything Trump does, from destroying political correctness to destroying globalism, destroying it, destroys them. It doesn't matter if he sells out or sold out. That's why he hasn't sold out. You speak these truths, it's big, long, black coffin nails driven right into their heart. You don't put stuff like this back in the bottle. Fight's already here. Like Patrick Henry said, our friends may cry peace, peace. There is no peace. There's already war in the north. The next gale will bring it here. Listen to our brethren. If you want to sell out, may your chains set lightly upon you, to paraphrase. But as for me, give me liberty or give me death. We're going to Roger, Joseph, and others here in a moment. I know your folks called for Pastor Manning, but he's gone now. You got sure great points to make. And then Diggs will pop in as soon as he gets there. He's in UCLA. I mean, it's like LA's lockdown, escape from LA. Two people got shot at UCLA in a city of 10 million people. Meanwhile, there's like probably 20 car deaths, motorcycle deaths, people being robbed, stabbed. But oh no, but when it's a shooting at a government facility, they have it all set up to lock everything down and let it go for hours where no one knows what's happened and no one knows what's this is how they brainwash the public against guns, to quote John P. Holdren. Oh, I'm sorry, that's the White House science czar that says he wants to kill you and your family with fluoride in the water. That's Eric Holder that does Fast and Furious, Oklahoma City, and other false flags. So let's go ahead and talk to Roger in Texas. You're on the air. Thanks for calling.
Alex, thanks for taking my call. I'm in San Antonio, a longtime listener, first-time caller.
Well, God bless you,
love
sir.
Your show. Thank you so much. And I'm an Indian American, and so what I've been doing, and you know, folks here in the U.S., a lot of folks, they don't know about the danger. I mean, everyone calls it radical Islam, but that's not it. The problem is Islam itself, and we, you know, India has been dealing with this for 1,400 years, and the way, and there's a thing called satya, and that is deception. And it says deceive the infidel. And once you're in, slit his throat. And we see that in London. We see the mayor. So Islam. It's
sure. So you've seen it before with the Western people coming in saying we're going to be friendly and then stabbing in the back. Yeah.
Absolutely. That's been happening for 1,400 years in India. And so I've been doing that. And the other thing, and when you're...
Sure. I mean, talking about India itself, and we normally think of India... you know, the subcontinent as east, or the Middle East as east, but the Middle East is west of that. So describe to folks, as a you know, true Indian from India, what Islam's done in India.
Well, for 1,400 years, they come in, they say, okay, we're going to be traders, we're going to be living peacefully, and then they come in, they migrate, and they're let in because they say we've been persecuted in our country, so let us in. And then they come in, and local people build them mosques and give them food and shelter and everything. And then they come in. The first thing they do is, because it's in the Quran, it says, take over, in order to subjugate your enemy, take over their women. And that's how you humiliate them and you subjugate them. So that's how they start. And then once it hits that critical mass, 10%, that's when they say, okay, we need our own Sharia. We need mosques. We need other people. We need all the infidels.
They call for the next wave to come in. No, it's admittedly a religion of conquest. That's what they teach. And then any Muslims that aren't part of that are actually heretics that are being hunted down by their more radical brethren. And of course, folks don't know there's a huge war with Islam in India because India has been invaded by it for 1,400 years, as you said, 1,300 years. What do you make of the Dalai Lama coming out and saying Germany shouldn't bring in the Muslims?
Now, that's so funny because, yeah, I have a lot of folks here, and first and second generation Indian Americans. They're kind of confused. They're like, okay, we're immigrants too. Should we be against all these Muslims coming in? But then what I've been doing is I do an initiation ceremony. I say anyone that becomes a new citizen, a naturalized citizen, you need to listen to the Alex Jones show. Because a lot of these folks, they're smart. And once they listen to a couple episodes of your show, and then they see, they connect the dots. They're like, oh, we've seen this before.
That's right.
We've
you don't see Indians system. Running around trying to, you know, blow buildings up or, you know, make everybody submit to their will.
Exactly. So I try to, in a way, I know, and that's what the pastor said as well. Sometimes I have to chain these folks into, you know, it's a kind of tough love. I say, hey, okay, you know, this country, invited all of us to come in and open its arms. It's our duty to come in. Once we become citizens, we need to make sure that this country is safe. And so that's their problem.
Sure. I mean, look at the Middle East. All they do is kill each other. It's because of the conquest nature of what Islam has turned into. There have been some periods when Islam was a better force than, you know, Christianity when it became dark. But the truth is now it's very radical. It's very conquest oriented. And the globalists and socialists are allied with it because they only want short-term power. They don't care about what happens in 50 years. Joe Biggs is getting in place right now. Helicopters are overhead. UCLA, two people shot. I was just watching Fox News. They're like, all white males must now get on the ground and put their hands up. How about the cops? But I kind of get it. If the suspect's a white male, they're coming out of the college. But two people been shot. They're now locking down a bunch of public schools, major highways. LA's being locked down. Total bedlam. Over two people shot. Who knows? And they're about to have like a Trigley puff, New World Order, anti-free speech events there. Is this a false flag? I don't know. The White House has been caught doing a false flag called Fast and Furious, and El Chapo's got U.S. government 50 cals. So when they've been caught doing it, they're the main suspects. Yes, is this a false flag? I want to ask that question. I'm not saying it's a false flag, a staged event, but if our government, run by criminals, has been caught running Fast and Furious and all these other events, time and time again to blame the Second Amendment, and the former attorney general said, brainwash the public against guns. Have they let another mentally ill person out to do this? Did they stage it? Is it a drill? They've done it before. Who knows? I'm not saying the average cop's involved. I'm saying this stinks to high heaven because Trump's coming out to the West Coast. You know, Hillary's out there pushing her anti-gun agenda. We got helicopters overhead of your TV viewer, Infowars.com/show. For radio listeners, Infowars.com/show to find the free video feed, iPad, iPod, Apple, Droid apps. It's all free right there at Infowars.com/show. But most people are listening on AM and FM radio right now, describing what's there. Joe Biggs reporting from the scene. He was there to cover all the social justice warriors running around demonizing the First Amendment, trying to shut down free speech. Joe Biggs, great job getting there so quickly. What is your intel?
So what I have so far is here at the UCLA campus, there has actually been possibly three dead. Police have actually found a gun, and it happened at the engineering number 4 building, is what I'm being told here by some of the locals. Now, there's been small groups of students being rushed out of here from the campus under this bridge here, and as you can see, there's tons of people on top, construction workers that were working on some of the buildings. They've been told to stand back. You've got police here. You've got a lot of media around through here as well. Talking or trying to talk to students as they come out. So far, many of them haven't said much, but we're going to be out here as much as we can. Hopefully, we can find out where Fox is getting their feed from, where all the police are. Maybe I can get over that way as well. But this was just the first spot that I could get to that I found. I'm not very familiar with this campus.
Well, I tell you, Joe, you're doing a great job. Be safe. But I mean, just the hysteria. It's on every news channel. LA's being locked down, hundreds of schools. It's just total hysteria. Over two people shot, and we're not getting details. Why aren't the police just storming in to wherever the supposed shooting happened? What is this thing with, like, hundreds of SWAT team guys standing around, you know, sitting on their thumbs?
Yeah, I don't know. It was interesting because last night, you know, I was up here covering the free speech event with Milo, and at that time, there were students that were being extremely violent, students who don't like free speech, students who hate really what America stands for. They hate freedom. And they were banging on these doors. Oh, we got a ton of cops swarming in right now.
Keep going, Joe.
And as that was happening, there were students banging on the outside, protesters trying to get into the building. And I was able to speak with Milo's agent just a little bit ago. And what they told me is they had left the event, went outside, were walking around, decided to go back inside. And when they were hanging out inside, there was a bomb threat called in on them, and the police had to usher them out. So I'm in the works of trying to get an interview with Milo's agent and have them talk about what happened to them in that situation. But now it's at the point where they're even worried about having this event today in Long Beach, where I was actually at earlier today.
Well, packed halls all over the country when a Breitbart editor goes screaming, trying to stop some gay guy from having free speech. These people are so shameful. And I've got a short clip I want to play with audio that's had the cuss words cut out. The fact we get 57 seconds out of like an hour of footage is amazing. There's so much cussing on this by these people. You think the only language they have is cuss words strung together as they try to shut down free speech. Let's play a clip of what Joe experienced last night. Here it is.
Oh, victim.
You, man. But you look like you look like him.
Don't let him have speech. Dumb look. My mommy put me in diapers till I was 10. Ooh. I mean, it's just... I guess we got to bleep out all this as the cuss words, but just total hysteria. They have no future, no jobs. The degrees are worthless. So they've just psych warfared them with high-tech brainwashing to just be hysterical idiots. Just screaming, shutting down speech. I mean, these people are morons. And by the way, we always debate them to come on the show. We tell them to. They won't do it. Joe, describe while you shoot footage of the helicopters and the police and the two supposedly shot, but they won't give us any details for hours, just dominating the news cycle. Oh, my God, there's guns everywhere. Oh, we're all dead. You know, great white sharks kill 50 million people a year. So do guns. We're all dead. Easter bunnies kill 5 billion. While all this hysteria is going on, this looks like a psyop to me that's gone on this long. Or this is just a paralyzed, wicked flee with none pursue. Comments on this, comments on being nesting with the social justice warriors.
Well, the interesting thing that happened last night, there were two of these social justice warriors that had skinheads, and I'm actually going to be walking around the campus. I'm going to see if I can get closer and get some good footage.
That's right, we're watching you.
There was two guys, there was a male and a female that had skin heads, and they were, as people were passing by with Donald Trump hats on, the Make America Great Again hats, they were screaming and calling them Nazis. So in the one confrontation, you see where the guy with the bald head, he looks at me. I was like, oh my God, look, it's a Nazi. And he goes, I'm a Jew, leave me alone. And he just starts screaming and flipping out. I was like, dude, I'm making fun of the fact that you're attacking people. You're pushing people that are trying to get into an event that promotes free speech. Yes, that's very much like a Nazi. I'm not talking about the fact that...
Exactly. They yell and attack you and want to shut you down. If you respond, they go, it's on video. I mean, they're nuts.
Yeah, completely and totally insane.
So what else happened?
Well, like I said, these people were... The women kept jumping. They were the most violent ones, too. The women would jump and back into these male reporters.
And they look like total mental patients. I mean, if I was trying to cast people to act like mentally ill zombies as a Hollywood producer, I would hire these women. I mean, these are basket cases.
Yeah, they were sitting here trying to play the victim. They would assault someone and then scream that they were a victim and then try to get the police to come over there to arrest them. I mean, it was complete and total insanity. And if you're watching, I'm actually going up a walkway right now that's going to overlook the campus, hopefully. I can see news crews off to the right. They're sitting there like good little boys doing their job on the corner. I'm going to actually try to get in close. And like they said, there still is an active shooter. A gun has been found. Possibly three people have been shot and killed out here. And this is the exact same place where Milo had his free speech event last night. And the whole thing about this, these guys are worried. I mean, that's what these insane people do.
They all right, Joe, you're going up on an overpass above a parking garage. Try to get a better vantage of things. Be careful. You are a white male. It was reported on Fox News. They showed them they're making all the white males lay down.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so I guess Aide Skrilak, who goes, you're an effing white male, you're not allowed to talk. I guess he's probably pleased right now, even though he's a white male.
Yeah. He's not too happy about his white privilege at this point, then.
In fact, do we have Aide Skrilak yet? Do we have him? Yeah, we can actually show some. There he is. There's Carl the Cuck.
I can see a bunch of police over here now. Looks like I'm walking into their area.
These people are funny. I should make jokes about all this. This is too crazy. Man, you got a city of 10 million people like locked down in hysteria over two shot right now.
You have to laugh at it because you have to laugh at it and you have to point out the insanity or else other people aren't going to see that it's wrong. That's what's happened. It's been a lack of parenting by some of these people. And these kids have been coddled their entire lives. They think they can run around acting like a bunch of crazy people without any kind of repercussions or anything like that.
All right, Joe, let me have you pause for a minute. I'm going to give some fair time under FCC rules, under fair use and under the fairness doctrine. I want to give Aide Skrilak, that our reporter, Rob New, got footage of, with what he responds intellectually to what you have to say. Here, let's go ahead and play that.
Issue.
So then you support the Iraqi war.
Explain to me how Trump is a Hitler.
people have been. There's Eric H. Cree, Lex Carl the Cuck, and what's the woman's name?
There's tons of police outside of this building. I think I'm at the right building now.
Yes, Joe, tell us what you're now seeing. Be careful.
All right, so I just came over this overpass area. Now I'm walking into where there's a whole bunch of students. Looks like there's tons of police lined up on both sides of the road over here. This seems to be the main area where
they've got yellow tape up everywhere. What is going on?
I'm going to try to zoom in. It doesn't let me look.
They got a bunch of police waiting there.
Yeah.
Got a lot of students there. Those look like police. Describe for TV viewers what you're seeing, Joe Biggs, or radio listeners.
So as we're seeing right now, there's a lot of people in this breezeway area. And we're looking over into where all the police have migrated to. This seems to be like the main area that they're focused on.
So there's a woman in wedge shoes right there in blue jeans. Let's talk to her real quick. To your left. There you go. Let's do more important work here. Where'd she go?
You guys know what's going on so far?
Yeah, there's actually, from what I gather, there's been a shooting in there.
Wait, sorry, he's just calling to do a phone
with us
right now.
Okay, cool.
What'd she say to you?
Thanks. He said he loves the show. He'll talk to us later.
Oh, really? What did she say?
She says that he's calling in to do an interview with her first.
Okay. She's like, thanks for trying to steal her big interview. Oh, my God. I love it. He's a fan of P-Brain. Anyways, Joe, keep going for radio listeners.
So as you can see, there's tons of police vehicle. Looks like there's SWAT officers coming up and down that way. On the other side here, there's a whole lot of police that have amassed. Helicopters are flying all over. But basically, most people are just kind of frozen right here, trying to figure out what's going on. Once again, if you're just joining, we're at the UCLA campus in Southern California around LA.
Man, look at, there's like dozens of police cars where you're at. And I heard they got like most of campus locked down, Joe.
Yeah, I mean, I've been able to walk around pretty easily so far. This is the first area I've really seen where there's tape and they're not allowing anybody to go in. But with
this, well, I mean, I've been watching the press conference. They still don't have any information. I mean, how many hours is this going to go on?
Yeah, it's been going on for about an hour and a half, 2 hours, I guess. Now
there it is. UCLA shooting. Another gun-free zone. Paul Watson, Infowars.com. Victim disarmament policy claims more lives. At least two people were killed during a shooting on UCLA campus today. And yet another victim disarmament gun-free zone. A UCLA police spokesperson said officers responded to a engineering lab and asked students to go to a secure location. How about they have guns to shoot the person? After the campus-wide alert system issued a notification, which is totally worthless. It's like having TSA but the borders open. At time of press, the gunman is still on the loose and has not been apprehended. According to California state law, gun ownership is strictly regulated on the campus of UCLA. Yeah, why is this always on gun-free zones, Joe Biggs?
Because criminals don't abide by laws. And therefore, when you make something a gun-free zone, you then make it a kill zone. That's a soft target. Criminals, bad guys who want to do harm, they don't go after something that's hard. Like, you don't run at a buffalo. You don't run at an elephant. Why? Because it's bigger than you and has a good chance of taking you out. Unless you have an elephant gun, which is the great equalizer. So you have to have things that make things an equalizer. And there's criminals out there that want to kill you. They just want to take your stuff. They don't care about you. They have no care about life. They don't care about
anything. And they all move to Chicago, L.A., New York, D.C., where they have a bunch of sheeple to feed on. I mean, if I was a predator, I'd want to go after the folks that Mark Dice interviews. These people do not know how to find their butt with both hands.
These are all Democrat states. These are all areas where there are people who are just completely brainwashed by this whole notion that if you take guns away, you're going to make everything happen.
Exactly. I'm no fan of Republicans. They got their problems. You know, a lot of them are dumb, too. But Democrats are the dumbest idiots. And they all talk about how smart they are, but they know nothing. I mean, they really are a plague of idiots.
Yeah, they're like the leading cause of death in America.
It's a good point. It's documented. Joe, just continuing here. I'm going to want you to go into the next hour off and on, popping in when David Knight is hosting. But obviously try to find, and you did a great job getting there, wherever the press conference is. Maybe we can give him the information, the intel, so you can actually get to one of these stupid press conferences, but we're not going to hear anything. I mean, I would ask in the press conference.
Do you know where a press conference would be at? Down there? Okay.
Anyway, yeah, just go into that line. They're fine. And then try to ask a question, as you've done other press conferences, This is another victim disarmament zone with like 500 cops. You can't find the guy. We don't expect you to find him. It's not your job. Your job's not to stop crime. It is to arrest people who have done bad things and bring them to the people's court, the jury, the grand jury. But another victim disarmament zone, your gun control doesn't work. It creates a vacuum for criminals to enter. Joe Biggs?
Exactly. And that's what we're seeing in all these other places. Look at all the other, look at history. Look at every time they've taken guns away from things like that, the place has fallen. Tyrants move in, they take over. And now we have a presidential candidate who wants to, this self-confessed socialist, and people are actually falling for him. They don't understand that they're basically jumping on a sword by voting for him.
But Dos Equis is getting rid of the most interesting man and actually getting Bernie Sanders to be the most interesting man, Joe.
God, I hope not.
I mean, sarcastic.
That'd be horrible. Yeah, I know.
It's a joke. Bernie's is the most idiotic moron you could have out there. But see, I think he believes what he spews. That's why they don't want him in power. They love socialism. Got an armored vehicle right there, huh, Joe?
Yeah, look at his disciples, though. Look at the people that show up to these free speech events. The fact that you see large amounts of Americans now completely against what America stands for, freedom of speech, freedom to protect yourself. And what's happening? Where are these people amassed at? Where you see all this stuff are the places where there are shootings all the time. They're soft targets. Soft targets are areas that always get hit. What happened when ISIS came to Texas, Alex? They got taken out. We got the Second Amendment there.
That's right, Joe Biggs. It's crazy you're out there to cover the social justice warriors led by Stay Puff, Triggly Puff. And then now you're right there in the middle of just this total hysteria. Large parts of L.A. shut down as hundreds of police run in all directions. Hell, there's hundreds where you're at, thousands, looking for somebody that's long gone. Might have been a drill, might have been a false flag. By the way, ElectroPure, the folks that make these amazing water filters that cut basically everything out at InfoWarsStore.com, they have got a new ElectroPure Breeze, one of the most incredible air filters ever. Just go see it for the price. Nothing gets close. It's so amazing. This is years in the making. It's 25% off plus $184 for this room filter. InfoWarsStore.com. Revolutionary air purifier is here. Look at it in study side by side with units as much as $900. $184 beats it. And that's introductory. That's savings of $65 off right now, or 26.02%. Also, Anthroplex is back in stock. Supermel Vitality. Lung Cleanse, a lot of really great high-quality products at InfoWarsStore.com. InfoWarsLife.com takes you right to the nutraceuticals section. Also, you get free shipping on orders of $50 or more, 10% off when you sign up for AutoShip. And there's so many other specials. Just go check out the Mothership store, InfoWarsStore.com, and check out the subpages like Maiden1776.com, InfoWarsLife.com. And if you want to find all the great longevity products, they're separate from us but are excellent. Over 400 products, and then your purchase supports the broadcast. You can go to InfoWarsHealth.com or InfoWarsTeam.com. They have Beyond Tangy Tangerine and Pollen Burst, other great products there. Joe Biggs, I know you're there. What's happened since the break started? You're at UCLA, side of the shooting. You were there to cover the anti-free speech mobs. Could this be a false flag, Joe? I mean, if the Justice Department got caught running fast and furious, CBS News, to blame the Second Amendment, could they have staged something here, Joe?
Okay, cool. There's some guy telling me if I go back over there again, I can't come back, but who cares? I'll still do it.
Was that a cop telling you that?
No, some campus patrol guy.
Oh, just some guy on a power trip. I'm sure he loves the Nord Order. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's fine. Who cares? I'll get around him. I was able to get through all the police in North Paris and Saint-Denis when the raids on the ISIS guys were happening, so I'm sure it's not going to be too hard for me to get past this guy.
Absolutely. Just another buck-toothed moron. Go ahead. So you heard my question. Could this be a false flag?
I mean, looking at what happened last night at the event, the fact that there was a bomb threat called, the fact that now this is happening the very next day after one of these events happens. I mean, it's really interesting when you see something like that happen. I mean, I don't know. It's too hard to tell right now. There's not a lot of information.
No, I hear you. Down. And because they have a past history of this, that's why I don't trust them. I'm just saying the possibility has to be admitted because they've done it before. It's like if a guy's a convicted child molester on your block and a kid gets molested, they're a suspect. We don't know they did it, but they've done it before, though.
Yeah, exactly. But you can see they've already got dogs out now. They got the canine police.
So here's the question. Like, will they keep L.A. locked down for days looking for the shooter, two dead?
Yeah, never know. Possibly. I mean, that's somebody's child or father that got shot. So, yeah, someone's going to keep looking.
It's very, very sad. I'm just saying, is how much of L.A. is locked down right now?
Well, it wasn't too bad. I mean, I got here in about 40 minutes from 45 minutes from Long Beach. But, you know, as I was on the way up here, this was kind of unfolding. And more police were on their way. And it looked like a lot of the overpasses and stuff started to have police parking under it. So,
sure, let me ask you this question. What would Trigglypuff or Age Skrillex do right now?
Cry and blame the fact that guns exist on it instead of actually being a realist and understanding that, guess what, they've been invented, they're here to stay, they're not going anywhere, and what we need to do is to have that great equalizer. Everyone needs to have a way to protect
themselves. Right. There's always going to be crazy people. Like in Japan, they have stabbings every week, some crazy, those, you know, stabs 18 people on a school bus. Do we ban knives? No. We try to identify Fruit Loops.
Yeah, it's insane the way that people try to weigh this out with, it's not rational thinking at all.
All right, I want to get your take on what you experience more with the social justice warriors and talk about this new superstar you've discovered on Infowars.com there at UCLA, Alice the Goon. We're back in 70 seconds. The David Knight's going to take over after that. Alice the Goon, Infowars.com/show for free feeds. Some stations don't carry the fourth hour. Stay with us. Spread the word. They hate it. Spread the word. The enemy hates it. They hate it. They hate it. They hate it. By the way, Joe Biggs is a great surfer. And he's a great wake surfer. My buddy Shane Steiner is an amazing surfer. And first time Joe came down here about 3 years ago before he got hired to do some interviews with us, he went on the lake. He just jumped on the wake surf and was doing all these great moves. Everybody was impressed. So there's some surf music for Joe Biggs. Surfing the lockdown of UCLA, the hysteria. Got to be 1,000 cops. 2 hours into this, lockdown, can't find the shooter, two dead. It's a tragedy, just as bad as, you know, the 10 people that are down the LA highways today. But the fetish of hating the guns. Joe, you're going to be following more of this tour at other universities as the Trigglypuffs try to shut down free speech. Tell us about that and other points.
Well, right now I have an update on the situation. Now, what I've heard so far is they believe it was a murder-suicide. They found a note, and they found a gun as well. So they're saying that the building
The big lockdown happened, but it was a murder-suicide. So much ado about nothing.
Yeah, that's what they're saying, but there's still an FBI command mobile command center here. The ATF, I just saw walk up the stairwell right up here. If you see, that's hard to get the microphone.
Sure, so the ATF, when they're not busy doing Oklahoma City, are there keeping you safe.
Yeah, so they're here, ATF, FBI, local LAPD, terrorism task force, all that stuff. But apparently that's the word, that it's a murder-suicide.
Do you think the ATF's over there shipping more 50 cals to El Chapo or rocket launchers?
I hope not.
I mean, the ATF's been caught so many false flags. Where do you start, Joe?
I mean, it's a corrupt organization. It's a large organization. Without that, any kind of oversight and people actually looking at what's going on, then you have a lot of these career politicians and basically people higher up in the ranks inside of these agencies that are basically politicians. Just like in the Army, once you get up to Sergeant Major, it's basically politics after that. And you get these people, they get turned, changed. That money gets handed to him from here to there, and it's easy for these people to get corrupt, and that's when you see the stuff happen.
And Bill Clinton says, I need to demonize the Patriot movement, so they blow up Oklahoma City.
Yeah, I mean, this is super intense. I mean, it sucks if something like this happens, you know, but at the end of the day, guess what? We don't blame guns for it, because like I said, they're
here. Well, I mean, my God, 10 people die a day in L.A. in car wrecks. Look it up. I mean, I'm not glad that happened either, but you don't blame drivers because there's some wrecks and deaths. The world isn't perfect. That's the way it is. Yeah.
But the most insane thing, Alex, is this whole gorilla thing now that people are talking about, how everyone's flipping out over. And some people say that the gorilla was black and that's why it got shot versus if it was a white gorilla.
I saw that.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's complete and total insanity. But guess what? No one even talked about the 10 people that were murdered in Chicago over the weekend. No one cared about that. No one cared about the fact that there are criminals running around.
That's a good point. Chicago is basically in civil war because they had the highest crime rate in the world last year. This year it's double. And now they're saying it's like breaking down. Where's that go, Joe?
I don't know. I mean, there's just going to be more and more people get killed. When are people going to wake up and actually open their eyes and go, you know what? The Democrats have not been doing a good job. When you look at these states, these cities that are run by these guys, these areas that don't have guns, this is where you see all the stuff happen. San Bernardino. I mean, look overseas. Paris, that's a gun-free zone. It's completely and totally
ridiculous. Absolutely. Let me ask you this. What's the response you've gotten from the police when they see you got an InfoWars flag on your mic?
Some people have given me thumbs up or kind of like, you kind of see them like, oh, hey, look, and then point or whatever. But outside of that, I usually don't get any kind of hostility.
Even I was about when I was to say, we mainly get positive feedback, which I'm not growling the police. They got their own problems. Society's collapsing. My God, a lot of them are horrible. I mean, the public's horrible. We're horrible. I'm horrible. But we only get a lot. Overall, like you saw in Ferguson and other areas, even though they were doing some bad stuff, we get positive, you know, response, don't we?
Well, yeah, there was a police officer, I'll never forget. It was when Jakari and I were standing outside of the mayor's office, and they had just burnt one of the police cars, lit it on fire, and Jakari and I were getting footage. One of the police officers goes, oh, hey, Joe Biggs. And I went, yeah. And he goes, oh, man, I really liked your video last night where you called me a grumpy old fart. And then he pulled out his baton and whacked me in the leg, but he was laughing while he was doing it.
He didn't do it too hard, did he?
No. I mean, he was just kind of like, get out of here and just like screwing with me.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It was kind of funny, but at the same time, pretty sick and messed up.
Yeah, well, you could have responded to that unlawful order by breaking his jaw, but whatever. Defend the Republic, folks.
Now the
Joe, stay there. You're going to ride shotgun with David Knight coming in. Stay with us. Joe Biggs is getting a new battery. David Knight is about to take over. Biggs will just be popping in from different locations with live coverage of the UCLA shooting. Now, they're now saying, the Associated Press here, a murder-suicide. So that happened over 2 hours ago. They responded 15 minutes into it. And I was just watching live footage on Fox News. Can we back that up and play that for TV viewers as we cover the media here? They have, like, all these women, Hispanic, white, and black women with their hands up when it was a white male and a supposed white woman that got shot. That's what they're saying. So, I mean, just randomly have the cops put their hands up, too. This is about becoming a suspect, being treated like a criminal. This is happening at 12:05 Pacific. That's 2 hours ago. We're in Central Time, 2:09. This is like 4 minutes ago. This is going on with 1,000-plus police. I mean, how do we trust the guys in the uniforms here or some woman here? And I'm not saying they're terrorists. I'm saying you just randomly just, line up a bunch of women here. You're a Hispanic woman, a black woman, a white woman. Here, the suspect was a white male, but let's just line you up. This is crazy. Joe Biggs is getting back to his car to get another battery. Doing a great job there. David Knight's about to take over with a huge raft of news. But notice, that's why I say support us. We're going to Bilderberg. We're going to RNC. We're going to DNC. We are covering every week now. We've got reporters all over the country. It ain't cheap. And I'm not complaining. I'm fighting as hard as I can. You guys buying the products are like oxygen in our bloodstream. And imagine we're in a boxing match. I've got the will to fight, but I'm old. I got a fighter's heart, but I need oxygen. And the more money you put into us, the more reporters, the more video editors, the more camera people, the more crew we have, the more writers, investigative journalists, anchors. And this is the liberating fight. This is the fight against tyranny. So we're running a bunch of specials. We've got a new incredible air filter that destroys the competition. That's close to $1,000. This is $180-something. And it's just amazing. The revolutionary Alexa Pure Breeze is available with ion cluster technology and more. It's got, 4 filters in it. Truly amazing. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com. And we've got a bunch of other specials running on nutraceuticals right now. But this is how we're able to have Joe Biggs, who loves to be on the road. What a fighter. What a tiger. What a lion. He is. What a sheepdog. He is just all over the country. He was on the East Coast, when they were trying to shut down free speech for veterans just 2 days ago. Now he's on the West Coast being attacked by these people. Videos going viral. I wanted to get him back up to briefly ask him about these new characters that tried to shut down his free speech that are linked up on InfoWars.com. But as soon as he comes back, we can talk about these anti-free speech goons that are just simply amazing in their vitriol. Here it is. Threat to freedom. Feminist goons. How are they feminists? They don't act like women. They don't look like women. And that's fine. They want to be men, but they want to tell women what to do. These women want to run women's lives, in my view, my opinion. They want to be the guy wearing the wife beater. They want to be
you know, the who's the guy I'm married with children, or the Archie Bunker. Feminist Amendment, First Amendment now, it's the Feminist Amendment, only they can talk. First Amendment now attacked as much as the Second. Alice the Goon and her fellow feminists, it's like a man, want to eradicate the First Amendment because free speech hurts their feelings. Let's now go ahead and turn. I'm going to hand the baton to my compadre, my friend, David Knight. Watch in the last 3 hours as you get ready for the show and doing research. This whole thing really smells in UCLA. I mean, let's say it's not a false flag. A murder-suicide, 2+ hours lockdown, top story in the country. This is how you really brainwash the public against guns. David Knight, the baton's yours.
Yeah, Alex, actually, you know, when we look at this, Alex, this is what we're seeing every time there's an incident. We see this overreaction. And as you're talking about these social justice warriors, I got to say, I expect it from a lot of these people. I really had a punch in my gut this last weekend when I watched the Libertarian Party select these statists for their presidential campaign. I watched them betray the Second Amendment, something I thought I would never see within the Libertarian Party. Let me read to you from the Libertarian Party platform. And this is what has been there the entire time I've known about the Libertarian Party 25 years ago. We oppose all laws at any level of government that would restrict, register, or monitor the ownership, manufacture, or transfer of firearms or ammunition. That's about as inclusive as you can get, saying we're not going to infringe your fundamental rights to keep and bear arms. And yet they elected a guy, Bill Weld, who was a rhino governor from Massachusetts. And as part of being a governor, he supported gun control measures, pretty much every gun control measure that Democrats want. And he did it 20, 25 years ago. Gary Johnson said, I've got to have this guy or I'm not going to run. And they wanted two governors on their ticket so they could be taken very seriously. This is what William Weld said to Jake Tapper. We got a clip of an interview, Jake Tapper asking him about his opinion on guns. Let's roll that clip.
Well, I'm a lifelong hunter and gun owner, and I don't think those proposals were out of the mainstream.
Feed me my audio.
At all. I distinguish between hunting guns and guns that really don't seem to have any hunting purpose or potential purpose. So that was the distinction I was drawing there. But that's an area where I think Gary and I can find common ground. I'm not worried about that issue.
Yeah. Okay. So, you know, he's going to ban assault weapons, whatever assault weapons are, because, you know, there's not a really good definition of that. It's just anything that looks scary to liberals. That's an assault weapon. It's an assault because it scares them, presumably. Okay, so they're going to ban that because they're not hunting rifles. You know, the word hunting is not in the Second Amendment, Governor Weld. I know you're the original libertarian, according to Gary Johnson, but it's not in there. And, of course, he would do all the rest of the gun prohibition tactics that the left would like, even including some things like banning ownership of guns for 21-year-olds or younger. Okay, but he says, I'm sure that we can reach an agreement with Governor Johnson. That was an interview with Jake Tapper, CNN, before the convention. And then as these guys got the nomination and the number two, and we covered this last night with Leanne McAdoo, we played some of the clips. So I've got some additional clips that I want to play with you today. Some things that you won't believe in terms of trade. And now we see that Obama is in Vietnam pushing the TPP, doing it with people that have been touted as Hillary Clinton's vice presidential picks. So we got some information coming up with that. But before we leave the gun issue, because we're talking about what's happening in L.A., we're talking about the massive overreaction of the police there for what appears to be a murder-suicide. They've got the whole place locked down under martial law. Of course, they don't declare martial law. They just do it. Okay, it's de facto martial law. As William Weld says this, he says, I'm sure we can reach common ground with Gary Johnson. When he and Gary Johnson got the nomination this last weekend, it's been reported that the guy who finished second, Austin Peterson, presented Gary Johnson with a replica of George Washington's pistol, a flintlock pistol. Okay, he made a very formal declaration. You now have my support and my gun and so forth and so on. When he left, Gary Johnson just tossed it in the trash, according to witnesses who were there. It's been reported from a number of different sources. It was reported by representatives who were there. It was reported in Liberty Hangout as well as other libertarian publications, bloggers. They took pictures of it. They put it on the web. They said they took it back, showed it to Austin Peterson. He Now has that gun back. But Austin Peterson doesn't want to make waves. See, this is about politics. And isn't it pathetic that something as small as the Libertarian Party, and of course they do have 50 state ballot access, that's something they have consistently done, but people who really don't have a chance of winning would sell out their principles like this. It really is sad to see people do this out of a political position. Of course, what they want to do is they want to get on the government teat, okay? They can get government subsidies if they get to 5% nationally. And so they put this ticket together, and as Gary Johnson said, William Weld is a connected guy. Now, he's connected to the Northeast establishment. He knows Mitt Romney. He knows all these Northeastern liberals, the establishment of the Republican Party, as well as the establishment of the Democrats. So they believe they can get some money, they can get 5%, and they are willing, the party who elected him, is willing to sell out to these two guys because they're both former governors. Now, real quickly, before we go to some of the other news, I wanted to give you some food recall information because I think this is very important. You need to understand and protect yourself. You need to understand how your food supply, like everything else, is very vulnerable. Look at this. Yesterday, General Mills recalls 10 million pounds of flour over a possible link to E. coli outbreaks in 20 different states. Now, these are brands Gold Medal, Signature Kitchen, Wondra Flour. They were sold at Safeway, Albertsons, Jewel, Shaw's, Vons, United, Randall's, and Acme across the country. Now, they say they haven't found any E. coli in any of their flour products, but they're recalling them out of, quote, an abundance of caution. Well, I'd say that's a lot of caution if you're going to recall 10 million pounds of flour. Why would they do that? Well, they've had 38 people that have come down with E. coli between December and May. Half of those people who became ill reported making something with General Mills flour. Some of those people may have eaten raw dough or batter, according to the company. So important thing here, first of all, don't eat raw dough. Secondly, your food supply is not as safe as you may think it is. Just because it comes in nice, clean packaging doesn't mean that some really nasty stuff can't find its way in there by accident or deliberately. Look at this story out of Taiwan. We got EcoWatch reporting on the 27th of May that Taiwan has recalled Quaker Oats products imported from the U.S. after detecting glyphosate in the oatmeal. They say a random inspection from Taiwan's Food and Drug Administration detected glyphosate in 10 out of 36 oatmeal products that tested. They exceeded the country's legal limit. Well, their legal limit is extremely low. See, they're not Americans. And Americans, we don't have a problem with that because we have a nice, cozy relationship between big agri lobbyists and the FDA. It's called regulatory capture. And so they say, well, because we have this nice relationship here, we're going to tolerate glyphosate in the food. They don't do that in Taiwan. They also don't allow the growing of GMO there. And if they bring in food that is genetically modified, they have to label it. And of course, that's the whole point of glyphosate. It's been designed by Monsanto to work with their Roundup products. They work hand in hand. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the fourth hour of the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. We're going to be taking the callers who've been on hold for a long time. And I got to take some new calls because I've got some stuff I want to cover, but I want to try to get the people who've been on hold. That's Michelle, Robert, and Chris. We'll be coming to you in just a moment. I'm going to go back to Joe Biggs because he's got an update as to what's happening there at UCLA with the shooting. Before I do, we have a new product that you may have heard earlier, Alexa Pure Breeze. This is an energy-efficient HEPA plus ion cluster air purification system. We're offering that now at InfoWarsStore.com at 25% off retail. That's $184.99. This introductory offer price. It has a four-stage purification process for superior air quality, a patented ion cluster technology that kills airborne microbes with a final byproduct of clean water, not ozone. And so this is something that you really need to take a look at. It's very important that you have clean air. You know, some of the basics that you want out of life, you got to have clean air, you got to have clean water, and then you need to look at your food supply and be careful about your food supply. But you have to have air and water. You can't go very long without air and water. This is one thing you can do to purify your air. Alexa Pure Breeze. You know, some of the air that we get indoors is some of the most polluted air you'll find anywhere. And some of that can be generated by you without even knowing it. So that's why it's important to have a purification system in your home. Let's go back to Joe Biggs, who's now at the site of the UCLA shooting. Joe?
Well, I'm actually
Were you on lockdown, though? Were you on the campus?
Yeah, I was on campus.
How long were you guys on lockdown for?
Probably, like, since 10 a.m.
So you've been on lockdown since 10 a.m.?
Yeah, since 10 a.m.
And what did the police come in and say? What did you guys find out? I mean, what were you doing when it happened?
Oh, I was just studying. Yeah, nothing. I have no idea. I heard so many different stories. One was like it was suicide. One was there was like two people killed, two people they're not sure what happened, and something about four shooters. So I'm not exactly sure.
Yeah, it's a telephone game. It always changes. Yeah.
Yes, exactly.
All right, well, thanks for your time. So what we've been given so far, David Knight, once again, if you're just joining us, I'm at the UCLA campus, where earlier there were reports of an active shooter. Comes to find out that there was actually a murder-suicide. They actually found a note and a gun. And I just spoke with police. They have actually given the all clear, and people are starting to move out now. A lot of the police are moving some of these lines down, letting people go out, allowing them to cross over into the different areas. And you can see students starting to come in and out of the buildings now.
Okay, so they're starting to take down the martial law there. Is that right?
Yeah. So were you on here when the lockdown happened?
Yeah, I was actually taking the final. I walked over at 9:30 this morning. I saw like the first cop car pull up and like whipped out like an assault rifle and like started yelling at the construction guys. And then I went straight over and had like to take a final. And then I went into lockdown like halfway through. So it's pretty crazy. But yeah.
How were the police? Were they just telling people to get on the ground or anything like that?
No, you know, I saw like the first cop come up, like very first one, like before like everyone started swarming, and like I saw that. I was like at 9:30 in the morning. I got my final. I like walked over. It was like across campus. It was actually like pretty far from Bolter, the engineering building, but I didn't see it during the height of everything.
Did I give you guys any kind of information as to what was going on? Why the cop went up? Do you have an idea?
Yeah, they had some of the administrators in the Murphy Hall building. They were calling us and giving us updates and stuff and, like, helping reassure people.
How were you feeling when you heard all that? What were you thinking?
It's crazy. It makes it hard to think about final, but it's crazy, you know? I don't know. Like, crazy people. What are you going to do? But
what do you think the answer is to stuff like this?
I'm for more gun control myself, but I don't know, you know. This sort of stuff's always going to happen. I feel like, I don't know. I think more gun control, to be honest, but whatever.
All right, well, there you have it. Thanks, man. There you have it. A victim of a gun-free zone thinks that more gun control is better.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that'll stop the criminals from getting it, won't it? Just like drug control has worked, doesn't it, Joe? We don't have drugs anymore because for 45 years we've had the war on drugs that prohibited drugs, so we don't have that problem anymore, do we? We have it in spades. Yeah, we have it in spades.
That's the best way to put it.
Yeah.
Exactly, because... Whenever you make something illegal, guess what? Criminals find a way to get it, and then it gets on the street. I mean, even our own government of criminals, Fast and Furious, trying to take guns, and what are they doing? Straw purchases, all this stuff, allowing other people to get it, and we get our own agents killed by it. It's ridiculous.
Precisely, because what you wind up with is the corruption of government, and the government gets involved in the illicit trade, and you see the intensity of it go up, just as we saw the intensity of alcohol and of drugs go up under alcohol prohibition, under drug prohibition. You're going to see a lot of very new, novel weapons once the legal restrictions come off of that. So it's going to get a lot more dangerous, and we already have seen what happened with Venezuela. Venezuela confiscated guns because their economy was crashing. They're hunting police on the streets and killing them for their weapons. That's what's going to happen to the police. They don't realize that here in this country.
Yes, exactly.
All right,
there's
that's
a whole other large group of students coming out. I'm going to go over here.
Well, thanks, Joe. That's Joe Biggs and UCLA. Stay with us. We're going to be right back, and we're going to go to some of our callers who've been holding for quite some time. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the fourth hour of the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight on this June 1st, 2016. You know, we've already gone through about half of the year. We've torn another month off of the calendar here. Hard to believe it's already June, but things are coming up on us pretty quickly. We're going to have the political conventions going to be coming up very shortly. We've got the California primary is going to be coming up next Tuesday. That's basically the end of it. And then we're going to have the conventions. It's going to be very interesting to see what happens with those. We've got some more political news. We also have news about stealth attacks on our laws and our privacy. We're going to talk about that coming up, as well as La Raza grooming the Castros to work with Hillary Clinton. At the same time, we've got these guys from Texas, O'Rourke and Castro, one of the Castro twins, traveling with Obama to sell the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Yeah, you know, Hillary says she's against that. She was for it before she was against it, and you can bet that if she gets in, she's going to run it through. Now, of course, Trump isn't. I believe Trump is legitimate and authentic on this issue. He's complained about NAFTA. He's complained about our unfair trade. You know, free trade is simply that. It's free trade. But when you have thousands of pages of regulations that are produced by people who are not accountable to you, that is not free trade. That is managed trade. It's trade that's being managed by people that you have absolutely no control over. People who are writing these trade agreements, they're essentially going to manage our economy from afar, and it will not be to our advantage. We've already seen how that works with NAFTA. And when we look at these secret laws, this is a story from the Drudge Report. Secret laws passed in the U.S. spike under Obama. We're going to talk about the many different ways that secret laws are created. You know, we had the American Revolution fought because of taxation without representation. We now have legislation without representation. Our Congress is not writing most of the laws. Most of the laws are being written by bureaucracies that report directly to the president. But this is a report about something that's a little bit different, something I wasn't even aware of until this article came out. Congress itself is passing secret laws that work hand in glove with the secret rulings from the secret court that is part of FISA. So we'll talk about all that. Before we do, I want to go to some of our callers who have been holding for a very long time. Michelle in Louisiana. Go ahead, Michelle. You're finally on. Thanks for holding.
Thank you. Thank you. This is Michael, a.k.a. Okay. Uncle Sam. First, I want to start out by thanking a contributor that saw me on Alex Jones' show with Marquette Daniels' interview, who gave me a large donation to get the videos I'm about to let you be aware of. The first one is Uncle Sam charged with simple assault for practicing free speech. I was charged last week by the New Orleans Police Department with simple assault for offending a social justice warrior.
No, you can't do that. Yeah.
Pardon?
Can't do that. Yeah. They're protected classes. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, well, the video is up. Uncle Sam charged with simple assault for practicing free speech. The other one was 2 days ago. There is a federal agent turned whistleblower, John Gondola, who has a site called Understanding the Threat. I interviewed his number one man in New Orleans. They have infiltrated Muslim mosques with people posing to be Muslim. They have uncovered a plot called Extraordinary Memorandum that is targeting the United States for downfall by the end of this year. It has marked terrorist targets that will happen this summer.
Well, I'm not surprised. And, you know, we have Obama is in a rush to get at least 10,000 immigrants and as refugees. And, of course, we have this story from CNS News saying there's 1,037 Syrian refugees admitted in the month of May. Only two of those were Christians. And what we're seeing here is nothing less than an attempt to replace the demographics in America. They want people who are not just the Muslim religion, but they want people from other countries who are going to see the federal government as their benefactor, who are going to be loyal to the federal government, who are going to be malleable by the federal government. And they want to replace the demographics. They want to have people here that are going to be beholden to them. And as part of that, they're going to be bringing in people that they can't vet. You know, when we look at this and we look at these statistics here, you got to say, if this is something that is about protecting people who are refugees, then wouldn't they be bringing in Christians at a higher rate? Because they're the ones who are the most at risk from ISIS. And why is it that we can't protect people in country? Why is it that so many of these immigrants that are coming in are young men who should be fighting ISIS in their own country? Men who should be going to war with the violent takeover, these terrorists who are in their country. Why are they fleeing the country, leaving the women and children largely behind and coming into this country? Young men of military age coming in. There's so much that's wrong about this. I'm not surprised at all, Michael, that there's somebody believes that they found some plots. I think this entire thing smells like a rat, and we've been saying that for a very long time. We know precisely what this is. We know that Obama wants to replace the demographics of this country. And it's not just Muslims, it's people from every part of the world who will come here and will be reliable dependents on the federal government. That's precisely what they're doing. I want to move on because we've had these other callers who've been waiting a long time. Let's go to Robert in Alabama. Robert, go ahead.
How you doing?
Doing good. Thanks for holding.
Yeah, I really appreciate it, Mr. Knight. And I want to thank Alex Jones for letting me on the show, you know. And what I want to talk about is I'm really upset with our current situation and everything with the government. And I'm a veteran, man. I've been over there in Iraq. I served 3 times. You know, I went through the deal over there, and I did the pain and suffering, and it just disheartens me, you know, what's happened with this country, you know? And
what are you concerned about? What are you concerned about that you see happening with the country?
Well, we've let all these immigrants come over there. We've held the battlefield over there in Iraq, and then Obama comes in. And he gives that battlefield back to the enemy. You know?
Yeah, that's something we saw happening in Vietnam, isn't it? They would go in, they would clear an area, they would win the area, and then they would just walk out again and turn it back over to the enemy. And people started to realize that after a few years, they really did not care at all about winning that war. They simply wanted to have a testing ground for their weapons. And if you go back and you look at the history of DARPA, we had the author who wrote the book, The Pentagon's Brain, Annie, I think her name is Annie Jacobson, if I can remember correctly. But she had an excellent expose where you see the beginnings of DARPA in the Vietnam War. It began as a testbed for weapons, is really what it was about. And we look at Obama now touring Vietnam with these people selling the Trans-Pacific Partnership. That's where this ultimately leads. This is global governance. They could care less about what happens to our soldiers. They're not interested in the welfare or the economy of our country. They're simply, yeah, Annie Jacobson. That's The Pentagon's Brain. It's a great book if you haven't read that. Filled with, it's a very compelling history of not just the Vietnam War, because it goes way beyond that. It begins before the Vietnam War, and it goes way beyond that. But you see how they betrayed the soldiers who fought in Vietnam. And now you've got Obama with Texas representatives, a couple of Democrat congressmen, O'Rourke, and Castro, who supported the Trans-Pacific, Trade Promotion Authority, the TPA, so they could ram through the TPP and the TTIP, the Transatlantic and Trans-Pacific Treaties. He's got them with him, and of course, they're being groomed for higher positions within the Democrat Party. Was there anything else you wanted to say, Robert, before I go on to Chris? I need to move on to the other caller real quickly. You want to wrap it up?
I just say one thing, because I'm really disturbed, because I reflected on Memorial Day, and this goes to Memorial Day, because I have relatives that actually fought the Nazis during World War II, you know, and I want to give my hat off to Joe Biggs for what he's doing out there in California. He's a true patriot and everything, and he's boots on the ground.
Yes.
But I want to say this about my family, you know, because my family served in World War II. And, you know, they fought the Nazis. A lot of people don't know this, but, you know, went through the Utah Beach, the Battle of the Bulge, all of that. And then, you know, man,
yeah, it was a tough time. And when we look at what happened, after we fought the Nazis, what did we wind up with? We wound up with Operation Paperclip. We brought back some of the most heinous war criminals you could find, scientists, and made them heads of our bioweapons technology, made them head of our rocket science, and that's what we've wound up with. And that's a key part of this story about DARPA. And eventually what they do is they wind up experimenting on Americans. One of the experiments on Americans, and you know, we talk about Tuskegee all the time, but, you know, just talk about what they did to people in Vietnam. Not just Americans, but people in Vietnam, the way they tested weapons on them. Thank you, Robert. Let's go to Chris in Georgia. Go ahead, Chris.
Hello, how are you?
Doing good. Go ahead. Thanks for holding.
And I just want to first say that I'm a 15-year-old who is an InfoWarrior, and my question to you is,
since people like me are waking up, I do go to public school and I do ask many people questions. And I mean, many people like me are waking up. So what? So my question to you is, what can people like me do to make a change?
Well, it's really an educational issue. And as you talk to people and they're going to hear you explaining things to them, it's going to be very different from what they've heard. Now, they're starting to hear this in the mainstream media. For the longest time, we didn't hear many of these different aspects. We didn't hear things about the secret 28 pages. Remember when that was first came up in the debates and Donald Trump talked about that? That was something that people had been talking about since the 9/11 Commission, for example. The people who were on the 9/11 Commission were talking about that. We've been talking about that for 15 years. Yet when Donald Trump brought it up, what did they do? We had National Review come out and say, Donald Trump sounds like an Alex Jones caller. They said he sounds like you, Chris. And they made fun of him. But then they started looking into it. And there was a report from 60 Minutes looking into this. And they went back and they talked again to the senators who were head of the Intelligence Committee, who were on the 9/11 Commission. They talked to them about what was going on. And these people who have been pushing this for 15 years, Democrats and Republicans, and you know what? It's not a conspiracy theory. It's a conspiracy fact. They have worked to cover this up. And as they start to uncover what was happening with the missing 28 pages, how they redacted information that they put in there about the Saudis, now the Saudis are saying, well, Saudi official press is coming back and saying, we think the American government had something to do with 9/11. So this whole conspiracy starts to unravel. So the point is, Chris, as you talk to people, at first there's going to be a reaction like, that can't be true. I've had that same reaction myself when I see a lot of this stuff. When I first found out Vladimir Lenin was sent into the Soviet Union in a sealed train with $10 million in gold by German central bankers to start the communist revolution. I thought, wait a minute, that's just too strange. I heard that from Alex, and it's like, I got to look that up. And it's like, well, he's right again. You know, you'll hear stuff like that that is really crazy, but it's true. They actually made a movie about it. They don't show it in America pretty much, but it's Ben Kingsley. I forget the name of the movie, but it's in, you can find it in Europe on DVD. I don't think you can even get it in America. They don't want you to think about the fact that there's, the communism in Russia, Marxism, was started by central bankers, the guys who give us most of our wars. So the key thing is to educate yourself and then not to be offended or surprised when people say, I find that hard to believe. Just be ready to show them the facts. That's why we show you the articles when we talk about these things, because we back up what we do. We give you links and we give you references to what we have done to back up the facts. The information is there. Most of the time, these are mainstream media sources. They bury it in the back of their websites or the back of their pages, papers, but it's there. And so we show those sources. So just be ready, Chris, to, first of all, educate yourself and then gradually educate other people and be patient with them. Understand that it's going to take them a while to understand what's going on. Thanks for holding. I want to, before we run out of time here, and we're getting pretty close to running out of time, I want to talk about these secret laws. And this is a story that was, I believe it was on the Drudge Report, secret laws passed in the U.S. spike under Obama. This is a story from Vocative. They say a new survey shows that for the past 30 years, Congress has steadily passed an increasing number of secret laws, provisions that are kept from the public eye. How about that? You're not allowed to know what these laws are. See, when you have a dark secret state where everything is hidden from you, even their laws now are secret. Isn't that amazing? Can you believe that? Even the laws now are going to be secret. Now, this is an Ohio State professor of law, Dakota Rudisill, I believe is the way you pronounce the name, went through this and found that more and more bills passed by Congress include provisions that allow for secret elements, which become law without the American people knowing what they contain. Now, I've talked a lot, and they go on the next paragraph, talking about the FISA Court. And I've talked for a long time about how the FISA Act, the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act, created a court that is creating these rulings. They're the ones who gave the quote-unquote search warrant for Mr. and Mrs. Verizon, as Rand Paul talks about it. They're the ones who said the NSA can do dragnet spying on the American people. They did this in secret. There was nobody advocating for us. This is not a true court. This is a single judge. And this is one person, one lawyer, who goes from the government to that single judge and says, I would like to do such and such. There's nobody arguing for the American people. There's nobody arguing for the Constitution. And as I point out in this, this study refers only to changes in U.S. law that come through secret acts of Congress. A president's executive order can also shape U.S. law. Well, theoretically, okay? In practice, yes. Not legally, not constitutionally. As can the classified FISA court, which secretly approves, among other things, warrants for NSA spying. They say FISA court rulings can set hidden legal precedents, as with the post-9/11 raw take order, which allowed agents at the NSA, FBI, CIA to share raw intelligence on Americans with fewer restrictions. In other words, what they have said is not only can they approve these warrantless searches on all Americans, dragnet searches, in violation of the Constitution, but they pretend and maintain that the FISA court can actually amend our Constitution and not let us know. And so now we find out that in addition to that, we've got Congress doing secret laws. They say Congress has enacted fewer and fewer laws since 1978. So they're letting the bureaucracy, who you have no control over, who are there perpetually. You can't even get remove these people. They answer strictly to the president. That's how Obama is using the EPA to destroy the coal industry, among other things, is with the legislation coming out of these bureaucracies like the EPA. But they say even as total laws passed have decreased, provisions in them, when they finally do pass these laws from Congress, can, quote, reasonably be read to make a classified change to the U.S. law. And they're doing it in secret. And they say, what do these secret laws say? We don't know. They keep them secret, and they can keep that secret. Welcome back to the fourth hour of the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. In this last segment, I want to continue talking about where our laws are going. You may not realize it, but the United Nations is writing new laws to govern how we drive. I'll get to that in just a moment. Before I do, we have a new product, Alexa Pure Breeze. This is an energy-efficient ion cluster air purification system. This will go through and run through 120 square feet every 12 minutes to change the air in your home. And, of course, inside your home is where you're going to have some of the greatest air pollution you're going to face anywhere many times. This is something that is very important for you. Just as you have to have a pure source of water, and we sell water filters as well to help you with that, you also need to pay attention to the air that you breathe, especially even in your own home. And right now, as an introductory sale, we have 25% off the Alexa Pure Breeze filter. That is a introductory price of $184.99. You can find that at InfoWarsStore.com. That's the Alexa Pure Breeze special offer for introductory offer, 25% off retail. And just before we went to break, I was talking about these secret laws that are being written by Congress. And, of course, we have FISA that is secretly violating the Fourth Amendment, amending our Constitution. But we even have Congress that is writing secret laws. And as they say in this article, as for what the secret laws say, we don't know because they're secret. And the person who exposed this says it's kind of remarkable in this age when everything leaks, there's not one single one of these addenda that has surfaced in 36 years. So we don't actually know what's in them. See, the only thing they keep secret is their hidden agenda. And this is no longer, folks, Jefferson's America. This is now becoming Kafka's America, the Stasi. And as he goes on to point out, we've had DARPA as a part of this, you know, the Pentagon's brain that we were just talking about earlier, and their Total Information Awareness Act. Think about what we told you last year when we were talking about Jade Helm. And of course, the subtitle of that was Mastering the Human Domain. That really refers, folks, to geospatial intelligence. It's about mapping out and tracking your activity, activity-based intelligence, taking a look at where you go, who you meet, what you do, mapping that out on the human domain, as they call it, a human map. It's geospatial intelligence. We now have these latest articles here. An appeals court, this is from The Intercept, an appeals court delivers a devastating blow to cell phone privacy advocates. What they're saying is that the metadata is not protected. But the metadata is the most valuable intelligence they can get from you. It's more valuable than your conversations or your texts because they can use that for predictive programming. That was what Total Information Awareness was about. It was about pre-crime. It was about minority report types of surveillance. That's why this is so serious. They say when law enforcement asks the company for cell phone records to track location data in a new investigation, is that a search under the Fourth Amendment? Oh, Of course it is, but the courts say no. So we have three politically appointed judges, and they say, well, a search isn't a search when we say it isn't a search. Then we see this coming out of Illinois. Someone is trying to gut America's strongest biometric privacy laws. This is something that Illinois had. That's the Biometric Information Privacy Act. They put it in 8 years ago, and it prohibited companies from making biometric scans of your body and putting that in their database. But now we've got corporations who see that they can make a profit from this. So they're quietly going in the back door and introducing legislation to gut this. They put it into a law that was called the Unclaimed Property Procedures Act, okay? Because you know what? It's your rights that are going unclaimed. You're letting these people take your rights. In Europe, they're saying, finally, we're going to get self-driving cars because of new United Nations laws. That's the way they're taking it, because you're not paying attention to where this is going. Join us tonight. That's the end of our show. We have no more time to go into this. Join us tonight, though, at 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern for the InfoWars Nightly.